All right, so I heard this the other night and I figured, fuck it, you know what? I'm gonna stream this. So here's Patrice O'Neal, Bill Burr, and fucking Anthony and the whole gang. It's funny. Take a listen. One moment.
I had to bring Patrice O'Neal down. He
Yes.
hasn't been on enough to even understand where the studio is. I had to introduce Patrice to the you
Yeah.
guys.
I love how there's
Steve.
no sense of urgency around here. Steve's
Nah.
just lumbering around when we really need a clip immediately. He's hanging with
Yes,
Patrice. What could he possibly be doing with you instead of doing what he needs to do with for the show right now?
He was I'll vouch for him.
Yeah, what
He
was he doing?
was peeing.
Oh, really?
Seeing Shawshank
Oh,
Redemption,
yeah.
it's just like
Stand up and wipe.
do you want a DVD, The Story of Seaweed from
Oh my
the Channel?
God!
See, that's it's too
I
inside,
know
but
it's
we will
inside.
bring it to the show
Steve
now.
hands fucking A&E biography shit to us. It's like, hey, stupid, I have cable. Get me something I can't get.
Every
Fucking.
day. You mentioned Rampage, that movie last
Yeah,
yesterday, or what is it called, Rampage?
Yeah.
All of a sudden, he goes, "You want a copy? Show me a
You
copy."
want to
No, I don't
copy?
want a copy.
Exactly. What do you go to the fucking $3.99 bin and fucking Virgin asshole?
I think he's the
Stop
last.
handing me A&E shit.
He's the last guy at Blockbuster.
Well, here's what happened.
If
Wait a minute. He offered you Rampage?
He offers.
Yeah, the movie
That one
Rampage.
might be a good one.
But I'm
Okay, maybe
saying,
that's a bad example.
isn't
But
that a good move to do?
One time, that was a bad example.
Fuck! I wish I could remember all the stuff he's offered.
Dude,
It's
here's what it
embarrassing.
is. The channels that like
Oh.
want
Steve,
us.
bring in all the DVDs we said no to. He's got to have them down the hall.
And
You're going to be
bring
amazed by
Rampage,
the
by the way.
horseshit.
Because I've seen it in my mind, because I Wikipedia'd it, by the way.
Yeah.
I've seen the whole movie
It's a good one.
On paper.
What?
But I want to see it
What?
actually.
It's a good one, man.
What?
Rampage.
Rampage. Rampage.
And he did get me a Black Sabbath biography on A&E, which
it's
I started
biography.
watching. It was tremendous.
Now, some of those things are fine. Like, but he'll come up to us with, like I said, the
Bring
story
the
of
whole
seaweed.
stack.
And you're like, because these channels want us to talk about them. So there are popular shows like, what are some of the fucking popular
Do you
shows
want to
on
see
there?
this new series, Horses of the Adirondacks?
Yes,
no,
like that.
We
no,
don't.
Like Mythbusters.
Well, Mythbusters is cool, but like, yeah, a lot of that kind of stuff, like, you know, like 2 episodes of American Pickers. You know, which it's not like, you know,
but
whatever.
You guys are not good for the self-esteem. It's just,
you know what? Fuck
the
that.
One thing I learned from the great Vince McMahon when I wrote on the WWE is he never made you feel like a complete asshole.
Really?
So it's like,
well, that's his problem.
It's like
yeah,
you
we
fucking
like
with a self-esteem. It's like, here, guys, I thought of you, and it's like, go, you know
no.
what? Let me stick this up my ass
oh, really?
And call you a faggot.
All right,
like,
wait.
Like he'll come up, with Deadliest Catch.
Thank you. Hold on,
A show that's popular, Deadliest Catch.
Right.
So he'll come up with like a DVD of that, and you'll be like, all right. But then there's 20 DVDs.
Well, that's
he's
what I'm
trying
trying to get
you.
At. Sam is running down the
and
hall
because
he's the biggest
well,
prick.
You guys, this is you know. Let me tell you something.
Wait, no, Sam, get on mic and sell
as
these
an,
things.
As an outsider, this is Operation Valkyrie against Steve.
Oh, yeah? Wait till you hear what he offered us, and then let's see if you have the same opinion.
All right,
I
here
got
we
it,
go.
Sam. This is some of the stuff that that Steve has actually offered us.
The new Pierce Brosnan film, The Greatest.
Let me see that. All right.
I do want to see that.
What is that one?
I don't know.
There it goes.
Season one of Spike TV's The Deadliest Warrior.
What is that? I never heard of it.
Wait, I'll tell you what it is.
All
it's
right.
very interesting. This I was looking for. It is who the warriors of different times and different histories.
Uh-huh. Different histories.
Versus each other. Like a Mongolian horse rider.
Right.
Versus a ninja. And
okay.
who would win? And
that
they would break it
terrible.
Down. They break it down on who would
like
win.
Like weaponry and armor.
Yes,
and
who
shit
would
like
win.
That.
Yeah.
But here's what Steve does, which drives me nuts. He'll bring you guys. He'll offer you guys from his shows like Deadliest Catch, and he'll try to sell them. He'll go, "Hey, look, this is Ice Road Truckers. He's going to talk about the time that Phil had a flat." And no one gives a shit.
E-Rock is trying to get someone's attention here.
Most recently, before the show, he offered you this series called Life Without People.
Right.
And it wasn't even the start of the series. It was like season three. And you
yeah.
just looked at him and did your, no, right in his
no!
face.
No! I've seen them.
Exactly. It's about this fucking building.
I was actually too able to make out like a bandit recently.
Yeah.
Some of the perks of the job. I now own
Funny Farm on Blu-ray.
Aw, shit.
What is that?
Funny Farm. Chevy Chase is
Aw, funny. Shit. There are some movies that don't need to be converted to Blu-ray.
No.
That's it.
All right, let's go. What else has you offered?
Converted to CD.
Media only, of course. Yeah, it's in the white envelope. It's Python Hunters. If you want to check out Python Hunters.
Well. And self-explanatory. You don't need to... That sounds good.
How hard are they to catch?
You know what?
Sounds good.
Who hunts a python? You stumble upon them.
Patrice, it might sound good, but here's the deal. If I'm going through the channels, I'd be like, oh, Python, what is that? And I might put it on. I don't need to have it on DVD.
We want like Iron Man 2 offered to us, like stuff.
Good shit.
Maybe an Avatar.
Yeah. To not go poor.
Right, go ahead, Sam. Here's a Blu-ray that he offered us.
Well, it's not.
Is that fair for me to say? I'm not fair. Here enough to go poor.
Sam, go ahead.
You said a Blu-ray.
Well, I'm not here enough not to go poor.
Sam.
He said a Blu-ray, which is not accurate.
This is
it's what I did last night. Blu-ray.
It's a combo pack. Blu-ray DVD digital copy of the Scott Adkins, Michael Shannon Jenkins film, Undisputed 3, Redemption.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Patrice is just like, yeah.
Patrice is getting a lot of good stuff.
Tonight. Look, do you want this disc? It's all of the commercials they show before online clips now. There are 4 hours of them.
All right. Here's another one that was actually offered to us.
That was the one I brought in yesterday.
As mentioned in yesterday's Terry Crew
interview.
Oh,
it wasn't even Rampage. It was
the movie
that
nobody saw. Gerard Butler's Gamer.
Oh, Gamer.
That was my nickname when they thought my name was Murr.
This is transmutative content. This is not a copyright infringement by any means. Just wanted to make that clear.
Oh, this is a nice. This really is a nice pounding.
Oh, shit.
Go ahead.
Let's not forget. Do you guys like skateboarding? Because if you do, I've got the thing
for
you.
What do you have for it?
Life of Ryan.
Now I got to go.
It's
the
complete series, the MTV reality show about Ryan, a young skateboarder.
Stop.
You like wrestling a lot.
Holy shit! No, I know. I like
that's not.
Like, here's the thing. This guy, Zerkivo Opie and Anthony Episodes, that's the name of his channel. He's got 262,000 views. But this is not Opie and Anthony, and this is not... So how could... If this guy strikes me, it'll be ironic, right?
Far away. Somebody in here could love a little skateboarding.
There's a
Ryan.
Reality show about a little fucking punky wool-headed kid.
Ryan Sheckler. He's just 17 years old.
I remember him. I haven't seen him in many years. My mother told me he died.
It is perfect.
She always loves him more.
Oh, that's good. Kevin from Connecticut. I have the first season of Cop Rock.
Actually, it would be season 2 or something.
And for the record, I took home the Blu-ray of Ice Road Truckers.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How was it?
It was good. I loved that
that's
show.
That's actually not a bad show.
I loved that show.
All right, so what? You slip, you slide, you drop, you don't die.
The dumbest. A&E's, those things make my stomach turn. I'm really, I don't want to hear about how you died getting my lobster. Just fucking
get me my lobster.
Yeah, I don't want to go to the supermarket and pray every time I get fucking sea bass. Somebody fucking lost a leg for my shrimp. Fuck you, motherfucker. The dangers of delivering my pizza.
My favorite thing about Sam watching Blu-rays is that he has a standard definition television.
Oh, shit.
He watches his Blu-rays on and then tries to tell me that they look better than regular TV.
Sam has a cathode ray tube.
They look a little better.
Do you want a flat screen?
I would like one.
You don't have a flat screen?
No.
They're $7
too, you know.
Now. You can,
yeah, really.
They really
you
are.
Can, you can get them with...
You open up a bank account.
You can get them with that five chewing gum. They give you a flat screen so you can chew gum and watch television.
They sell them as an impulse buy by the registers.
I got my TV from Eric Nagel.
Yeah, the Nagel,
really?
The Nageltron.
Nageltron.
And they sell a Mexican that'll put it on your wall, too.
How many inches?
How many inches was it? Nageltron 3000.
I think it's 36.
Is that Ooh, wide?
Wow.
That fucking thing is so deep.
Have you gotten a 3D television yet?
Nah.
I'm not ready yet.
I ain't going for that
you
shit.
You got to wait a generation
or two. I'm not in for that shit.
Yeah.
How much does your TV weigh?
I mean, over 100 pounds, easy.
Jesus.
The screen also is kind of rounded. It's like a 3D TV.
You can carry them under your arm now.
TVs. That's because of the way the fucking ray has to be shot at the front of the at the phosphorus on the front of your tube.
It makes the
it has to have a consistent
good.
Distance, so it can't be flat, or else from the fulcrum point you would get a longer distance than from the center of the screen. That is why these screens were always curved.
Where you mean
a ray that goes back and forth real fast?
What do you mean we're always curved?
See, get a new television, you fuck!
How
I got the PS3.
Let me ask you, how long did it, besides the fact that Opa and I are looking at each other, and we both want to strangle you for knowing that?
Yeah, it's embarrassing.
I don't know.
You're making us feel really
We know you're right.
We don't even question it.
How long did it take to go to flat screen? Everything is flat screen, like every bar. Like that was the technology for fucking 50 years. And in like 3 years, it's gone.
I know, it's gone, except in fucking Sam's house.
But
it's just a practical thing. It had to happen, but it's like, you know, 8 tracks were replaced by cassettes. I swear to God, I thought cassettes
would never. But this one went fast.
Cassettes, we thought forever.
You'd be mini cassettes.
But DVDs are on the verge of fucking being corny now.
With just electronic media, that you just get electronic media now over the internet. You don't need a physical disc anymore.
Can I be a young white girl for a second? Is we got to throw all those things away. Where are these fucking, are they shooting them to the sun? Where are all the old televisions?
They shooting them to the
and
sun.
And the fucking old radios and old shit.
In landfills.
Where the fuck are, there are no more tube televisions. I guess you got a choice between LCD.
LSD, yeah.
LSD. LCD and...
LED.
And fucking, what's the other one?
They really don't pump out plasmas anymore.
What? Oh, plasma's done.
Yeah,
you can lose pixelation.
LCD, LED.
I got a plasma in my house.
My plasma's amazing, though. I have one for 5 years. It's amazing.
People like them when they have them, but you don't go and buy a plasma anymore.
Is that picture on an LCD or LED
better?
Yeah. They're amazing.
Jimmy, I saw the new LED, like the Samsung LED. Yeah. They're so super thin, and they look so good. Like, I thought my TV was awesome for a while, and then I had to finally concede and be like,
my Pioneer Elite really is fucking, plasma is amazing.
It's the
picture.
By the way, here's where our televisions and all of our electronics end up, and I'm not even shitting you. Somehow, they end up in giant mountainous heaps in South America and Africa, where young children will pick the fucking silver, solder, and gold and shit, and then give them to the fucking head muckety-muck so they can make money, and the little kids go home with their little chewed-up fingers with a piece of beef jerky.
That's all right, so they don't go to waste.
At least someone's making out.
Exactly. Little flies on their little chewed up fingertips all night long, just eating.
Flies and fucking TV gold.
TV gold.
Back to Sam. What else has been offered, Sam, by Steve?
Well, we spoke of A&E just a minute ago.
Yes, we did.
You only think you know them, the Jacksons, a family dynasty.
Wasn't that a reality show that was supposed to be happening?
It is a reality show, and we have it on DVD.
Is it still on?
I guess it is. It's a terrible show.
No one watches it, I guess.
Of course it is. It's about Randy and his family.
It's A&E's number one show. It happened right after Michael died.
Yeah.
It's their number one show.
Really?
Did you watch?
I wouldn't know.
No, it
looks awful.
Yeah, they all got plastic surgery and shit. They're uncomfortable to watch.
And finally, I think this one's
is only
perfect
for
you guys, especially Anthony. You may want to take this home.
Yes.
Gene Simmons' Family Jewels, the best of seasons 1 and 2. If you want to.
Is it empty?
even Jimmy's not taking that.
Here, I don't need
Jimmy's
that
a huge
garbage.
Kiss fan, and he's not even looking at it.
I have already.
That fake fucking scripted reality, which is worse
than
reality.
It's called assisted reality.
Assisted reality? Because scripted sounds bad, so they came up with assisted reality, which means fake-a-tee-ly.
To be honest, not one of these things was good. I really want to defend Steve. They just all stink.
Well, I took home the Funny Farm Blu-ray. Apache versus Gladiator, Viking versus Samurai, Spartan versus Ninja. I give it to the Ninja, because he just creeps up on the Spartan and kills him.
You could watch the show. Is there a hot girl in Ice Road Truckers?
Yes, there is. Versus Taliban.
Bob in Jersey. Bob.
Give it to Taliban.
Hey, Bob.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Yeah. Good evening.
Yeah. Ice Road Truckers, I called an episode of that the other day, and there was a girl on there, the hottest one on there, if you can believe that, the trucker, you know. And she says to all the guys, that her boss included, she needs to take bigger loads to prove how good a driver she is. But the whole episode was just dedicated. You got to get clips of the sound. It's really funny.
What did she... Wait, dude, what did he say?
She wants to take bigger loads.
Yeah, she needs to take bigger loads to prove
you
that
just
she's
ruined my
fuck it up.
Oh, OB.
I'm sorry.
Oh, literal OB.
I'm sorry.
I just wanted to give you the look.
I don't feel too good about myself right now.
I wanted to steal the Jimmy bit anyway. So. All right. I was just going to steal Jimmy's bit.
Steve wrote down a very important bit of information.
I'm heating up. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, man.
He wrote, you guys did, and he underlined the D and did. All right, so let me read it. You guys
like did. My house.
You guys did say yes to Billy Hayes. That was a National Geographic show. Yes, but we've moved on.
And not only that, we also said hi to him because it was a fucking major motion picture back in the 70s. A huge event that happened, and it happened to be on a channel.
That was a great interview, I heard.
Oh, that was fun.
That guy was fantastic.
We got to get him back.
Yeah, get us guys who've been in jail for at least 4 years in this lake.
That's
what
we need.
You get Ryan Sheckler if you want to...
You from the life of Ryan. Said that he passed away.
You didn't ask about the titty on the glass, though.
No, we didn't get to a lobby. We should have had a longer
shit.
Hangout.
I was listening to that. And I go, who is going to ask the titty on the
you're
glass?
Right.
I thought it was
there
Norton
was so
going to do
shit
it.
Going on with the
we had so much more to talk to him about. We should have had him for longer.
And speaking of Billy,
Burr in studio,
a guy in a prison of his own kind, Bill Burr.
Yes, Bill Burr.
What's going on?
Welcome.
How are you?
Very good.
Thank
sir.
You for taking me last second.
Of course. You flew in to do Letterman, but you got bumped because of Joan Rivers, and now you got to fly back to L.A.?
It was going to go Joan Rivers, me, and then, what's his face there? Steve Winwood.
Oh, Steve Winwood.
Steve Winwood.
Yeah, when did you find out you were bumped?
How about they bump Steve Winwood for you?
Fuck.
Enough
with
Steve Winwood.
Legend who sold out stadiums for 30 years.
Enough.
That's what I got there.
I'm trying to help you out.
Give you my take on motherhood. No, it's one of those things. Joan Rivers was killing.
Yeah.
She was hilarious. And, you know, they were talking about, you know, the whole, you know, when Carson just stopped talking to her.
Wow.
Like, evidently, went up against him, he never talked to her again, ever.
Never.
Like, not even, like, on his deathbed, be like, maybe I overreacted. It was over. So it was compelling to listen to.
She called, I think, Johnny to say, like, I'm sorry your son died when his son was killed. Yeah. No response. But he was a motherfucker, man.
Yeah, she said, when he called up, be like, yeah, listen, I'm kind of doing a show that's going up against yours, but, you know, you are the king.
Wham!
Click. Hung up. She called him back. He hung up on her again.
Wow.
And that was it.
Never again.
Never again. That's that old school pre-Dr. Phil.
Yeah.
How did that make you feel, Johnny Carson? Like, there's none of that.
Nope. Click. Yep. Fuck you.
Cunch. Yeah. Click. Goodbye.
Oh, that is old school showbiz, too. Oh, hold a grudge forever.
I gotta see that documentary.
Dude, you're better off not following that, though. Who wants to follow such... Because she's a legend. She's funny, talking about something that we all know. You don't want to follow that, man. Probably better off on another episode. Oh, she's great, man.
She's like Mickey Rourke. You hear all stupid stories.
He really is fucked
up. Dude, she's the vicious. She's the edgiest
ever seen in comic, dude. Dick Don dumb Rickles yesterday. That stunk to high. I wanted to kick the TV with that stupid Don Rickles.
No, it's good.
Bad.
Hey, hockey puck.
No, what we saw there.
But Jimmy was showing us that clip saying that Don Rickles killed.
I never got hockey puck.
It stunk.
He did kill.
Hey, look at you. You fucking booty booty. Like, I'm going to kick him in his fucking prostate. That is fucking...
You're not a Don Rickles fan.
Douche. I love Don Rickles, but that particular clip.
That was a typical set.
He looked at the guy. He looked at the music director at one point. He goes, hey, the doctor called. You died an hour ago. It was fucking funny, man.
I don't like his love for Borscht Belt.
I don't love them.
Loves Borscht.
I don't.
Belts.
No, I don't. I don't love those guys. I respect them.
Some of the Borscht Belt comics.
Oh, Buddy Hackett did, which Jay Moore loves Buddy Hackett. They're all funny.
I like the Buddy Hackett.
Here's what I love about that age. The one thing. Mm-hmm. Not the 50 things. But my favorite is the whole... What we don't have now, I think all of us have a sense where we could be as funny as them in the future with television, is that camaraderie. It's the Dean Martin roast.
Right.
And you knew they fucking knew each other and they loved each other. And it's like, that impressed. But when you see fucking That fucking commemoration or whatever the fuck that was, I'm sitting there like, you know, Norton, somebody turned it off because
it was a great example. You didn't watch the whole thing. I'm telling you, I watched the whole thing as a comedian. The magnitude of the gig. It was Reagan's inaugural.
Fair enough.
It was 6,000 people or whatever. Reagan and Nancy are there. It's all of Washington, and Rickles just went on and was Rickles. But to watch him do it in that setting, it was impressive as a comedian. The magnitude of that gig for a comic.
I'll give you that.
I like it in context.
That's what was impressive about it.
But he didn't put it in context, Jesse. He said, this is phenomenal.
No, but it just didn't
go over well just on the radio.
Of course not. But I even said you shouldn't play it on radio. I said you shouldn't. Yeah. It wouldn't work on radio. Just Google it when you get home. And when you watch him work, it was Ronald Reagan. I mean, I know they knew each other, but he's an old man.
What he's saying is, I have to agree with it, but I'm just saying that sometimes you get caught up in stuff of the greatness of old.
Right. All I know is
Joan Rivers is a great, but it's just like,
I was sitting waiting for a funny moment.
Dude, when she called
Brigitte
Nielsen a cunt on her own show, when she had the internet, Joan Rivers is the most vicious comic ever.
She
is.
John
Rickles trashed Ed Sullivan on his own show. Did you ever see that clip?
Genius.
Was that
it
for him?
He's going, Ed, I love you. You're beautiful, but get your teeth scraped. Ed Sullivan had these Austin Powers teeth, so he seems smiling like he's trying to be a good sport, but you see he's livid. And I think he knew he was never coming back, so he just went off. I think it was something like Ed Sullivan's wife was in the front row, and they go, don't make fun of her, and he couldn't not, so he made fun of her, and then he goes, sorry, I love you, Ed, you're beautiful, but get your teeth scraped. And then he handed him the microphone, kissed him on the cheek, and walked off.
That was the last you ever Don Rickles is amazing. Some should be. Look, Roger Cabler is better than fucking Rich Little. I want somebody to stop putting Rich Little. It's this
Rich Little.
After a while, when is somebody going to say Rich Little is maybe the worst?
There on Carson in his tuxedo. He came out. You all remember as a kid going, oh, look, he's doing it.
We've done the bit, though. Patrice is absolutely right. His impressions have always sucked. We just didn't realize. We just never realized.
Rich Little did a fucking... He did a great Carson and a few great ones, but he did a Pink Panther. His Pink Panther was so
bad.
Let's
get these clips.
It made me uncomfortable.
Yeah. He thought Richard Nixon was always going to be funny. He was like doing Nixon in 1990.
I'm not a crook.
Well, I'm not a crook. Like, doing like college gigs.
Dumb Johnny Carson he would do.
Take Monday off.
What?
Leno's been in the seat 15 years. He's still doing his Johnny.
Dropkick him when he sees him.
How about you work on your Jay Leno impression, you fucking...
He's doing a prom gig. Mammy, how I love you. How I love you, mammy.
Kids are just confused.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
You fucking suck.
Let's get the clips. We need someone on the machine. Because I got to see the Ed Sullivan thing.
Yankee Doodle Dandy.
You dirty rat. You dirty rat. You killed my brother.
And there's 18-year-olds in the audience. That's great.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
The great Rich Little, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it up for him.
He's doing fucking SUNY Delhi. Who is that motherfucker?
He's desperately trying to be contemporary.
All right.
His DMX was in Gone with the Wind. It was a little bit like
and he
this.
Still turns around.
Yes.
And then becomes the
person.
I'll tell you what's a bad one?
Up your nose with a rubber hose.
No, you know what's still a really bad one? Is Robin Williams, Jack Nicholson at the Oscars every other year. Anytime he's bombing, he does this really bad, I don't know, it's almost as bad as me presenting when he's at the Oscars.
What's he doing?
Wait, Danny's in here.
Danny, could you find
any clip? The Rich Little, what was
doing the Pink Panther?
Oh, the Pink Panther.
Dude, it went on for too long, and he put the jacket on, and there was the music, like, ba-doo, ba-doo.
No!
I was like, all right.
I'm so glad we're giving him a beating.
It was fucking humiliating.
I'm so glad we're giving him a beating.
Dude, he would go like, and then I'm like, self declaim, and you're like, you don't sound like him. He doesn't talk like that.
He only sounded like two guys out of his 100 impressions.
Dude, but he wouldn't stop doing it. It was like, how long are you going to be him?
Oh, don't find it. I don't even want
to
see it.
As long as we need to do it.
Do we know which one it is? Any of these clips look for
Simon Starrick, girls.
That's like when Billy Crystal does the fucking black guy.
The black jazz guy? After Katrina, a Buddha da boo boo dee doo, I lost my favorite trumpet. Can you dig it? I knew you could. La boo boo da doo dee da. And where was Mr. Bush when we all needed the help that we. Shut up!
Woo! And it goes on forever. Yeah, yeah.
Woo woo!
Oh, he thinks he's doing Mudbone.
Yeah. Exactly. Hey, can we find the Ed Sullivan, not Ed Sullivan, the Ed McMahon clip?
The
that one might be easier to find. One?
Can you stop it? I wish you would.
Ed McMahon and Don Rickles, yeah.
There's no Rich Little. We can't find that one, huh?
Can't find
it's
it yet.
It's got to be Rich
down the
Little.
Hall, he probably got take a look 40 for people trying to take his horse
shit
off the
internet. It's so bad.
Is this the one, Bill?
I'm dying to see how bad that is. This is a Carson clip.
Warmth, Don Rickles.
Oh, come on, man. You can't. This is a classic.
This is classic. I'm just going with the music. I like it. This is old school. Yeah. Good. Oh.
And Johnny was a funny fucker, too.
Yeah, hilarious. Yeah.
Look at you've stood a mighty Carson art player.
I want to get frog fungus. Sorry, I didn't have time to tidy up here.
No, it's okay.
Jews don't work zoos. Ever seen a Jewish wine tamer?
Never. You never hear Lou Lipschitz in a cage with a tiger. We've seen him in a cage, but that's another story.
How anyway,
a little Holocaust.
Fine, John, it's been a long time.
Yeah, well, you've been busy with other things.
That's.
And I heard the other party's story, and
well,
I'm going to help her get all we can get.
By the way, to make fun of Carson divorce. About his divorce on the show.
Yeah, now, come on, dude. Play my premium blend from 10 years ago. It's going to be brutal.
What's up with Crisscross? It's funny, actually. No, dude, I mean, it's fucking funny, I think. To actually,
no, we're in. We're
dude, the
in.
Balls, okay, the right, balls to in. Do that. To yeah, the I'm balls not... to sit there and make fun of his divorce to his face. Look, nobody would make fun of Johnny's divorce.
Yeah, obviously the material's dated, but you could appreciate what the fuck he was doing at the time.
Right, right, right,
it's
funny.
I thought we were going to look at what's-his-face doing the Pink Panther.
I wanted
we're
to see
to
that.
Find that. But I want to see the Ed McMahon of
And the thing about Don Rickles, too, he was righteously that. That's what is the best thing. But he's just righteously a fucking whatever he's doing now.
Right. Was that at the end of the clip, Bill? Because maybe we could move forward and... get to him.
Oh, I didn't bring this up. This one wasn't me.
Who brought up the end of that?
I don't know.
Because you see what he just, I think Danny just decided to put Don Rickles on.
no, we were talking about Don.
No, we were talking about Rich Little, and he was looking for Rich Little.
We also talked about how Don Rickles beat the shit out of Ed McMahon, who brought it up on the show.
I guess you just did.
I didn't know shit about this.
Hopi, why did you bring this up?
The scraping of the teeth.
That's Ed Sullivan.
Oh, that's Ed Sullivan.
But you see what he's doing on what you call, and again, I love Chris Rock. I'm just, I talk shit about it's fun, but everybody was jerking off Chris Rock just alluding to Letterman in his situation.
Right, right.
And Rickles is just digging in his ass.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Right, so Johnny's you see how far we've kind of. What's irreverent is this? He's just like, I'm going to help her get money.
And Johnny was getting fucked in the ass by his ex-wife.
Oh my God. What's edgy now is so, like, really? Did you just do something?
Do you understand that Reagan thing? He fucking did a black joke right up front. You don't see that anymore. No one's doing racial humor.
Jimmy's still trying to sell it.
That fucking thing stunk. Because I'm going to tell you why.
Jimmy's trying to sell it.
It's the context. Now that he says the context, we can all have watched it with no, but Jimmy said it with this heartfelt love in his heart for dude, put this on. And no. And the tear in his left eye, and it's like, this stinks.
But I didn't say put it on. It wouldn't be. I said Google it and hockey watch puck. It. It's 5 minutes.
Yeah, I didn't like hockey puck either.
Call him hockey
puck. But they couldn't curse back then. You couldn't say douchebag. Or right. You had a certain limitation that you couldn't, you know. They weren't PC, but you couldn't allude to sex.
Well,
I'm stupid.
I want to thank
Eric. I'm going to go down swinging.
I can't believe we can't really find any about, Rich Little.
You talk about Hulk Hogan. His story about Don Rickles is on that last Hulk Hogan hand.
Oh, yeah,
that's
yeah.
going up before he shakes his finger and he's going to get up.
There isn't one Rich Little fucking impression on
this. Wait. I got something. Eric T, go to richlittle.com/voices for the douche chills. Yeah, all right, we can go right there. Something.
Rich Little.
All right, this is on the letter.
Hold on.
Hold on to your balls, people.
What percentage of voices are going to be accurate?
Zero.
Nah, you got to give him maybe
Who's it gonna
Carol
do?
Channing.
Who's he going to do?
Carol Channing. He'll do Reagan. He'll do Reagan well. He'll do Nixon well.
Everyone does Reagan. There's no one who doesn't do Reagan at this point.
Archie and Edith Bunker. That's going to kill.
Right, hold on.
He's going to sing the theme song.
What year is it?
That's what I'm trying to get at. It's 4 years ago, so you got to put
only
it in context.
4 years ago?
So what impressions would he do 4 years ago?
He's going to try to do some modern ones.
Bush. That's what I'm saying.
He'll try Bush.
He'll try George Bush.
Or Clinton.
I guarantee he won't try Bush.
He'll try Clinton.
Nope.
He will do Bush after he does. Hold on.
He's not talented enough to do Bush.
He will do Bush after he does. Nixon and Reagan.
That never stops.
Here's what he'll do.
Let's
make some money.
$20
here's what
right
he'll
now.
Do. He'll say Bush. He'll allude to Bush and say Bush is not anything like the old presidents.
Right.
When I came
he's
up,
gotta
it
get
was
back to
Nixon.
The old presidents. I'm telling he's doing Nixon and Reagan and a little Bush.
Yeah. He looks skinnier though.
I bet Nixon's giving Bush some advice.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't be a crook. Yeah.
All presidents are giving Bush advice.
Yeah, we got it. What else?
I bet he does Bush, though.
What else?
I bet he does.
I say Clinton.
Bush.
He
doesn't do it. How much? I got
Bill Clinton.
No, I got $20 that he does.
I'm not a gambler, but I will put. I put
dude,
10.
He definitely does.
I put 10.
He definitely does a little Bush.
I say
Clinton because Clinton's an easier impression.
But he's
going to
do a lot of old presidents to get to a little Bush.
Put your money up, motherfucker. Shut the fuck up and put your $10. I bet he doesn't do Bush.
He does fucking Bush.
I bet he doesn't.
What else does he do?
Give me the 10. I'll give you 20. We're set.
All right, good.
We're all set. Whoever fucking.
No, I don't care if he does Bush.
The second he does George W., I am fucking grabbing that 20, motherfucker.
I'll put it in your reach. I'll let it down because he's not going to do fucking Bush.
Wait, what actors will he do? He'll do Nicholson.
Don't do Nicholson.
Dude.
He's not it's 4 years relevant ago. Enough
Clint
to do Bush.
Yeah,
he's
doing Bush.
He thinks he has to. He's doing Bush.
He's going to think he's got to do it. Because Clint Eastwood has been...
directing.
Back in the day, and now he's still around.
Dude, he's done every standing president impression at the time the president was in
Bush.
There. Everyone.
You lost your money.
I'm really confident he won't do Bush.
Hey, we're in.
He'll do Dana Carvey's
we're
church
we're in on this together. Make sure I get a fucking 5 out of that.
I deserve something.
You have halves and halves?
Well, I got my money down over
there?
Here. Yes.
Okay, it's the two and two tens. Let's do
covering it.
Let's fucking do it. There's no way
hold on. What else is he doing? What else would he do?
4 years ago, 2004.
No, 2006.
Lucille Ball. Jesus he'll do
Christ,
Lucille
I'm
Ball.
Christ, I'm finished.
Lucille Ball.
Lucille Ball.
Oh, Lucy.
Yeah. That was from 1952, ladies and gentlemen.
Wouldn't it be funny if he did all barbaric impressions? Like, this is, these are the Yates children. Completely career-ending moments.
This is the AIDS,
Sullivan.
The African AIDS fly.
Whoa.
Lacey Peterson, ladies and gentlemen.
He'll do Carson.
Ed Sullivan. He'll do Sullivan.
Because he's in Sullivan Theater. Absolutely, I agree with that.
You remember this theater?
He'll do a Sullivan Carson thing.
You're right.
And Johnny.
He will not do George Bush.
You're right.
I think he's going to be
money.
Hilarious. I think he's going to kill it.
All right, let's just go with it. Here we go.
Thanks.
Oh, no.
He looks young, actually.
No, he doesn't.
Looks good. Yeah.
Looks like Todd Glass.
Oh, we got money on our fucking Rich Little act.
Regis, who is Dean Martin?
Letterman.
You know, I've been doing impressions for a long, long, long time.
Have you?
And I think the key to staying on top is to keep your act fresh, to come up with some new people.
Now, pause.
Pause.
He's going to make fun of himself and do old ones.
And do old ones.
Of course. Because I have not done that.
He'll say something like, I have not done
this
that.
This is
right.
Burt Lancaster. If he'll be raped.
Patrice's like, come on, motherfucker.
Burt Lancaster.
I want that money, man.
So Spiro Agnew.
All right. Spiro Agnew.
You're done, man.
So dumb. He's calling himself out, but he's not going to do new ones.
Right. Nelson Rockefeller.
Yeah, you could be right, the agenda.
Nope. Making fun of himself.
Right. Nope.
Go ahead.
Like Dr. Phil.
I know that you know. And if you knew that I knew that,
I lost.
Then we both would know. If we knew.
That's not bad.
I was wrong.
Very good. I'm gonna tell you, it stunk, and I'm gonna tell you why.
I'm gonna tell you why I fucking
lost. Because he doesn't care that he stinks.
He doesn't care. He never has cared.
He's gonna do Bush.
You're
God
out.
God damn it.
He's
come
not.
On. Come on, we got.
I mean, for just as bad as I thought it was going to be, I thought that was pretty good.
I have to agree.
You sound like fucking. What are we going to do? Jimmy Stewart.
But even the jokes were like, you know, Phil goes nowhere.
It doesn't. Nothing happens.
All right, here we go. Let's go.
It's a great opener.
Fuck. Who's the president?
Now, I've done a lot of politicians.
Oh, shit.
I've done people like Bill Clinton.
I was right.
Who wrote me a lot of great material.
That's horrible. It doesn't sound like him.
And George W. Bush.
There's my money, motherfucker!
Jesus, Patrice, he was at 30 seconds in.
God damn!
Give me five of that! But I did. I did submit.
You know what you are? You're rich.
I did submit that he doesn't give a fuck. That he stinks is why he does Bush.
Play that Bill Clinton again. Dead on. And it was dead on.
Hold on.
He
sounded more like Bill Burr.
And if you don't count the applause that he got when they introduced him, he went into Bush within like 30 fucking seconds of his act.
Fuck.
But the Clinton
so why I don't gamble. So I do not gamble.
So bad.
Clinton was terrible.
Let's hear his Clinton and into his Bush. Because I.
Fucking Blue Yeti, Mike. All right, let's go into this clip cold, I guess, right now. So this is Black Woman Goes Off on Black Lives Matter.
And I said, Joe! You are the racist! Right. The racist is you! Yep. It's because the white guy killed that. You think they're racist? The racist is Black Lives Matter! Go to Chicago! They don't have schools.
Okay.
And they die every day. They don't matter. They don't have because you can't get attention from that.
So right off the rip, I'm going to say, so she's not like your typical, what's the term? Black person, African-American, whatever you want to call. I call them people, you know, person. She has an accent. She's probably from like, I don't know, some island. Who maybe Nigeria. Who knows, right? But all right, let's keep watching here.
Shut up! Group of hypocrites! Go to Southeast DC, Northeast, tell them Black Lives Matter! If it matters, it should matter everywhere! You guys are hypocrites! Attention seekers! Attention seekers! Black lives should matter everywhere! It doesn't take a white cop to kill a black person to matter!
So I'm here today because I heard about a demonstration on, you know, the.
All right, come on, guys. What do you think her nationality is?
George Floyd event, situation, which I'm going to be honest about it. It's wrong that, you know, anything like that should happen, okay?
See, now I learned a long time ago, I think maybe it was on the Howard Stern show, that you shouldn't really call people African-American. Well, I learned actually in anthropology class that you call people what they call themselves. You don't call somebody a Native American. I mean, if you want to be all PC, if you want to take PC all the way, right? You call somebody what they call themselves. If they're Iroquois, you call them Iroquois. If they're, you know, Lakota, you call them Lakota. You don't call them all Native Americans, right? So a lot of people who are from Jamaica and shit like that, they don't like to be called African Americans. I'm not from Africa, man. You know, so.
It's very wrong. My problem is it shouldn't be an opportunity for a group of people to use that as an excuse or to come across as victims. No one is a victim here. The only victim here is George Floyd. Let's be very clear.
Every
everybody knows that black kills black more than anything. You know that. It doesn't take a white person to kill them for you to come out. Hypocrites.
Just leave.
You leave.
I'm present.
Make
you leave.
Let me leave.
I don't want to
make me leave. Bunch of hypocrites. Black lives matter only when a white person touch a black person. Do you know how many black kids got killed in Northeast DC this morning? What did you do? You guys are the racists.
What did you do besides come out here and provoke shit?
No, go out there and tell the black people black lives matter.
Go out there and help them.
Go tell the black person black lives matter. Then they will take you seriously. Everybody thinks you guys are a joke.
You a joke because you play. Go out there and do it. You a joke.
What are you doing for the Chicago kids who are dying every day?
What you doing?
Do you go there and judge a black lives matter?
You go.
Make me go.
You go.
Make me go.
You're so supportive of them. Go.
Make me go. As an American citizen, I'm proud of this country. I love this country. I don't want my country to be portrayed like this. We have a problem. That agreed. We have a problem in our country. Agreed. Okay? Too much violence. But it should not be categorized as a symbolism for racism on blacks. No. We are in a free country. Let me be very clear. We have foreign news media here. Our country is going to be portrayed the way they want our country to be portrayed, and which is not accurate. My point.
What do you guys think is more like, okay, let's break shit down for a second. Let's get real. If you're going for a job interview, right? Okay, what do you think is going to be more of an issue for your employer? How much you bust your ass, how much profit you can make for the company, your demeanor, favoritism, nepotism, a million other things other than race. I mean, in 2020, yes, obviously there was a time when this was more of an issue, but I feel like in this day and age, yeah, you're never going to solve racism altogether, but I think it's far more stigmatized to be a racist than it is to be a person of race. Am I right?
Point was that black kids in Chicago get killed every single day. Where is the Black Lives Matter in Chicago? Where are they? When black people kill black people, they don't come out and do this crap. The only time they do this crap is when a white person touches them. They are the racist. Because white cops, it's wrong for a white cop to kill a black person, that's for sure. But if it matters, it should matter at all times.
So what are you fighting for? What are you fighting for? You are not here to fight injustice. You're here to cause drama.
If I had to take a guess, they're talking about in the chat, that Africans like hate African Americans. It's probably because they complain, some of them do, about what their plight here when they're fucking over there like eating dirt just so their stomach doesn't hurt of hunger. I don't know. I'm thinking it has something to do with that though. I'm not sure.
Violence. It's not about blacks.
In a unicorn world. That's not a unicorn world.
I think it's like the same way that like Arabs or Iranians and a bunch of people from the Middle East, they come over here and they're like, what the fuck are you guys bitching about? Like, oh my God, all you got to do is work your ass off and not sleep and just, save all your money and not go out and party and you'll be successful. Like, what the hell's wrong with you?
Okay, since you're so...
You get it, so blacks are oppressed. I am black, I'm not oppressed. I am free.
That's good for you. That's an individual person. What about a systemic issue?
Where? I am black. I've always wanted to be. I have I do what I want. You have the skills. This is a country where you have the skills. You want to do what you want. You do it. Okay. Stop forcing on people to accept that they're oppressed. They are not. I am not oppressed. I am black. That's stop right. Making people accept that they're oppressed. You're forcing a rhetoric into your mind, which is not true.
See, the problem with our culture, too, is like, okay, she has an opinion or whatever, but now that she has all the eyes of these people, she's like, oh, I'm going to grandstand. You know what I mean?
That's my point. Okay. Violence is wrong, period. It's not about blacks.
Of course.
You agree that whites kill whites too, right?
Of course.
Have you seen any white person coming out and saying white life matter or white thing? No.
This has been my kick on this shit. It's like, think of all the time that people spend watching the news and commenting in comment sections on YouTube videos and organizing and making Facebook groups about hating Trump and hating this person or hating the Democrats and watching all of this shit and ingesting this media that is just there to reaffirm beliefs that you supposedly already have, right? What if you took that energy and all of that, you know, time and put it into fixing your own life or helping your neighbor out or a friend or a relative? What if you did that? Imagine how much better the world would be.
Violence is wrong.
They literally do all the time. Every time there's a Black Lives Matter protest, a white person.
It's a violence problem. The blacks kill blacks in black neighborhoods every single day. I've never seen a Black Lives Matter in those neighborhoods. Never. Never. You know what they say? When a black person kill a black in a black neighborhood, they come out and they say, when the police comes, you know what they tell the police? Snitches get stitches. Snitches get stitches. But if a white person kill a black person, Black Lives Matter. Stop the hypocrisy. Nobody takes this seriously. Nobody. If it matters, it should matter in black neighborhoods. You start cleaning at home.
So why don't you
start your kids at home?
Why don't you start?
I'm not carrying anything saying Black Lives Matter. If a white person kill a black person, Black Lives Matter. Snitches get stitches. But if a white person kill a black person, Black Lives Matter. Stop the hypocrisy. Nobody takes this seriously. Nobody. If it matters, it should matter in black neighborhoods. You start cleaning at home.
Why don't you go?
You
why don't
start
you start? Your
kids at home.
Why don't you start?
I'm not carrying anything saying Black Lives Matter. I know I matter.
Why don't you start?
You guys are wasting everybody's time. Okay?
Since you're so
black, black more than any race. Where's the Black Lives Matter?
All right, enough for her. We'll go back to Patrice O'Neill for a minute so I get another video. Thank you guys for stopping by tonight. I appreciate it. This is kind of like an impromptu thing. I had a chance, so figured why not?
I don't think he does all that much, Bush.
That's what I'm saying. Fuck.
I think you're right.
He had Bill Clinton.
To do it, though. He does. Fuck.
You listen
he was
to Daryl
known for doing politicians.
Fuck. You listen to Daryl Hammond's Bill Clinton. Know, you're like, oh, that's how you do Clinton.
Yep.
What is he talking about?
Put the bodies with the other one.
Now, I've done a lot of politicians over the years. I've done people like Bill Clinton, who wrote me a lot of great material.
That sounds nothing.
That sounds horrible. No, that sounds like Rich Little just saying something with the name Bill Clinton on it.
With like a little laryngitis.
It's terrible.
Like indigestion. Bill Clinton.
And when he's just talking, he sounds like Andy Rooney. Listen for the Andy Rooney.
Yeah, his voice is shot. If you're an impressionist and your voice comes out like this anyway, you're pretty much done. You're sunk.
And George W. Bush. I don't know why the American people are picking on me. I haven't done anything.
Not as bad as his Clinton.
And it's not as bad.
Nah. He actually fuck. Nah.
The loudest condemnation this morning is for police in Buffalo. A moment of violence caught on camera, and we're going to show it to you, and you should be...
All right, so you guys all know about the 75-year-old white guy, right? That was pushed down in the chat. Give me, put an F in the chat for the 75-year-old guy that cracked his skull, please. And let's have a moment of silence for him. All right, but beyond that, I guess he was some type of agitator, whatever that is, an Antifa agitator. I don't know how much truth there is to that. I should investigate a little bit more, but my point is, he wasn't some like little sweetheart, trying to return a baton. Apparently he had some type of device, and if you look closely at his hand, he's waving his phone by their fucking equipment. He's trying to fucking scramble their radio signal. So let's take a look at this.
Prepared, because it's very difficult to watch as a man in his 70s is knocked down by officers.
You see his hand? Watch his hand. They weren't doing anything to him at all yet.
He is fleeing!
He's not up here! He's not up here! He's over here!
I want to play that in slow motion, alright guys? 1 second. It might take me a second. I'm a boomer.
Down by officers.
Watch his hand.
Boo!
change that before I fucking die.
He is bleeding
out of his ears. Bleeding out of his ears. Get somebody over here. He's bleeding out of his ear. Get a medic.
What the f***? I'm going to get back.
I hate to go all Alex Jones tinfoil hat, but that was very mysterious hand movement right there.
Get off the steps. Let's go. Get back.
And what kind, as you can what see there, before Trojan an officer moves in front of the 75-year-old. Oh, and by the way, how far did that white privilege get him? That's interesting. Let's talk about that.
Camera, another protester is arrested. It's a reporter with the news outlet that recorded the incident who tells police to get an ambulance for the man. Buffalo's mayor says the 75-year-old is in serious but stable condition.
So is there racism? Sure. Yeah, I guess. But I have a problem when people tell me, when I say all lives matter, they're like, racist motherfucker. I'm like, wait a second. How have we gotten to a point where when I say all lives matter, I'm somehow, you know, totally turning my back to an entire race? It's like, no, dude. And people are like, you know, Black Lives Matter. That's it's, you know, they'll be like, bro, if you got a broken finger, you don't say, hey, you don't tell the doctor, listen, all bones matter. It's like, okay, you're trying to use some twisted ass logic. It's like, if you tell the doctor all bones matter, he'll take care of the fucking broken bone. You know what I mean? Without being exclusionary and divisive. It's like, I have no problem talking about race. If there's a racist law out there, hey man, I'll be out there right with you. I'll be marching out there. I'll be fucking, you know, I'll be out there and I'll have my voice out there for sure. You know, you can't treat fucking people differently based on skin color, right? That's why affirmative action is garbage. I mean, other than that, I can't really think of a racist law on the books. That being said, there's definitely a class situation going on. You know, it's not a race issue. It just happens to be, like, okay, for instance, if they thought Floyd was a fucking doctor or a congressman, but they didn't because he was wanted for fraud already, right? And he had a pretty extensive violent past and record and shit. I'm not sure if they knew about that by the time that dude had his knee on his neck or not. Maybe he did. He should have. But if he thought that was a doctor or a lawyer, a congressman, or fucking anybody who had any type of power, it doesn't matter what that skin color is. He's not going to have his knee on his neck like that. And that's the problem that we have in this country.
He goes on to call the incident, quote, disheartening. New York's governor, Andrew Cuomo, calls what happened utterly disgraceful. Two officers involved are now suspended, and an internal police investigation is underway.
Shit. Yeah. Let's get rid of that. Go back to my boy.
Money there for some reason. You should be just picking your own money. There should be some money happening.
Yeah, I get
five. It was a pot. Yeah.
I didn't know that somebody else was in on this fucking bet. I thought it was $10 But
I yelled like 80 times that I'm in on this.
Oh yeah. By the way, a lot of these same people. If you're so concerned, like, this is the thing about a lot of SJWs, especially. I know a lot of people that support Black Lives Matter movement aren't SJWs, but I'm talking about the SJWs specifically, right? If you care so much about lives, why the fuck are you supporting abortion? Let's think about that, right? How many African-American babies do you support being killed a year? And that's the other thing, too, is how am I supposed to take seriously when somebody morally postulates towards me, when they're totally okay with the murder of unborn children? That's like, I can't get on board with you. I'm sorry. I can't even have a discussion with somebody who's like twisted and fucked up like that.
I get 15 of this because the 10 is changed.
I tell you what was fucking up. I owe you 10.
Why?
I owe you $10.
Yeah, it's not just me.
Yeah,
and against
I bet
your
you
because
so you guys bet the same thing against me, and I owe okay. I owe Opie
so
10
you owe
bucks.
Me fucking $10.
Hey, yeah. I want to see the rest of this.
I do too, actually.
Oh yes. wait!
Double or nothing? Does he
Hold
do
on,
George
I got
Burns?
Bet. I got another bet.
What? Maybe I might get in.
He
there.
Just said, you know, he's done a lot of politicians over the years. He did that, and then he goes, but my favorite, and then we cut it off. Who's his favorite?
Oh, Nixon. Good bet.
Do you think it's either going to be Nixon or Ronald Reagan?
Nixon.
He looks like
Dude.
Nixon.
No, it's going to go Reagan. He's going to be too afraid.
Shit,
the thing
bet.
That screwed his career was
Not
he kept doing
bet?
Nixon.
I say
you
Nixon.
You want a bet?
I'm fucking nervous.
And 10 on Nixon right here.
I got 10 bucks on Ronald Reagan.
I got 10 on Nixon.
10 on Reagan.
I got 10 on Reagan.
Where's your
10? Just put it all down there.
Now I'm scared. Right.
I'm taking
scared.
I'm taking this.
Nixon.
Now whoever
Nixon.
Wins gets that.
On, Reagan. Reagan.
And you owe me 10, motherfucker.
I got Reagan. So if he does both,
I got
it's
Reagan
a push,
too,
right?
Yeah.
You
oh,
know
wait,
what?
On Reagan?
I got Reagan.
And now I'm getting confused.
What, you put in 10?
10.
Reagan was alive when he did this. That might have been a safer bet because Nixon was dead 4 years ago, I believe. Reagan's easier to do.
And Reagan Nixon. With Alzheimer's is hilarious.
And it's more...
so fucking Nixon.
You know what? Fuck.
Reagan's more topical.
Nixon.
That's
so
interesting because he had Alzheimer's. That might have been a bad fucking thing.
Yep.
Oh, maybe he wouldn't bring it up.
I say Nixon.
No, he's still got to do it. It's...
This Nixon. Is Ronald Reagan, who's now shitting his pants.
God damn it, I
well, where did her tits go?
Yeah,
well.
I'm too nervous.
Let's go, Nixon.
I think I'm going to agree with Bill, though, with Reagan.
Nixon.
I'm going to say
Now
Reagan.
I really
Nixon.
Can't recall.
Nixon.
Yeah. You see, now you see if all of a sudden he just started talking about fucking Honduras and everything.
I remember everything, yes.
Nixon for the win. Let's roll.
Nixon.
Come on, Reagan.
But my favorite politician by far was always Ronald Reagan.
Oh, yeah! Yes, motherfucker! Oh! Ronald fucking Reagan, bitch!
Thank you.
Patrice, give me my 10. I ran out of money.
Nice. I am fucking making a fortune on fucking Rich Little.
Where's my 10 money? Shit, you owe me 10. Where's my 10?
Yeah, you owe him 10.
You get it from Patrice. He owes me 10.
You know what? Anthony probably just watched this. Piece of shit.
That.
You're a big Rich Little fan.
Thank you. Give me a 10. Thank you, sir.
So you transferred the 10. I owe you over
the bill. Yeah, where are you?
I know. He watched it last night. They're going to take him in the back room. Look what they did to my hand, man. Yeah.
You can take Rich Little or the hammer.
Yeah.
Fuck. Look at Anthony's Fuck. Really...
He really is happy.
Nailing this.
Ronald Reagan, please.
Shit. You said Nixon?
I did, and I switched to Reagan, but my original was Nixon.
When
so
he
Nixon.
Started going, I'm like, he's going to say Richard Nixon.
Fuck.
And then it was Ronald Reagan. Oh, an upset right at
Excuse
the line.
I don't want to hear your process of winning. This is not a big victory. You guessed one out of two hack impressions. It was Iggy or Nicholson.
It was either red or black. I mean,
I didn't like his emotional victory lap.
Gambling.
Of course.
This is great. It is. It's just
gambling. I had to bring Patrice.
He'll do Reagan. He'll do Reagan well. He'll do
Reagan.
There we go.
Who wrote me a lot of great material.
Say Nicholson just because it's one of his benchmarks.
Next one?
Right. No, not next one, but before.
I do a Donna impression that goes, hey, I'm Italian. Go fuck yourself. I don't know. That's all right.
Say the ones you're saying.
Okay. I think he's going to avoid
it's
them.
It's before what you're saying.
Okay.
So
everyone just come up with a name and if really whoever try. Gets.
Uncle Jeff. Let the wheeze. I can't.
Eddie Deason.
I'm sorry.
And how much is this bet? $5.
I'll wake everybody up.
Let's go.
Because everyone's in.
Let's go 1,000.
But we're doing Nicholson. No, he's doing.
You have $5. I could borrow.
Oh, 40
Jesus
and white
Christ,
is.
Opie. I'm so lame. I'm so lame. The only day I need money, I don't have it.
I say Cronkite.
You say Cronkite.
I do.
I'm saying Nicholson.
I'm saying Brokaw.
Before.
And
says,
who's he doing now?
This is Andy Rooney.
Andy Rooney.
Andy Rooney.
So he's kind of. I think he's going to sag into other fucking news guys.
News guys, you think?
Yeah, I think so, man.
Who do you think, Bill?
Who's that guy who used to do the puppet with his thumb?
Cinco Valentis.
Yeah, he's going to do him.
With Topo Gigio?
Topo Gigio.
I'm going to piggyback. I'm going to go Tom Brokaw, too. I'm going Tom Brokaw, too.
Wait, that means you're going to split my money if I win.
No, I got nothing. All right, he's gonna get Pam Dauber. I don't have anything.
No, I mean, Jack Nicholson, you stole my brain when you said Jack Nicholson. I don't know what to say.
Come up with one.
Yeah.
All right, Chad, I got a question for you. And not just Chad, anybody who's watching the replay, right? Do you feel like that you have more control in your life? Let's say it's like a hourglass, like, you know, 50-50, like, you know, situation. Do you feel like you have more than 50% of control over your life compared to the outside world? Or do you think the outside world has more than 50% of an effect on what happens to you in your life? Just curious. That's because usually you can tell a lot about somebody based on which one of those they choose.
But where'd you hide it inside something small, I bet?
Do you want Nicholson? I'll give you Nicholson because I'm changing mine.
Oh shit!
I'm not gonna take Nicholson. I don't want Nicholson. It's just that now here's what 2004. I'm trying
six,
to think
six,
of
six.
Two, oh Jesus, six. I'm sorry. 2006
might make a difference. I don't know.
Maybe 2006 is what?
That's what you have to. That's why
he's
gonna
do
great.
Homer
you
Simpson
to
get the
shit.
Kids. Homer
oh,
Simpson.
Wow! Fuck, all right, Bill Burr's got Homer
there
Simpson.
There we go.
Damn,
Homer Simpson.
That's a good one.
That's strong.
That is a good one.
Homer,
strong.
Fuck, I'm taking Nicholson.
He needs a bit to bring him back to the kids.
What was a big? Movie in 06?
That's what you got to figure out on your own.
Yeah, can't be doing any research.
Don't do any research. Patrice, what do you got? Is it $5 a man? $10? What are we doing?
I'll put in 10.
And if he does a setup here, then we could do some side betting as well.
We'll do 10. $10. Here it is. I think I say Nicholson before any of the ones you guys said.
Okay.
And that's what we got. You got Homer before any of the ones we said.
I say we play this tape before the listeners fall asleep.
Yeah. Ready? Yeah. Ready? Yeah.
They're in.
Ready? Ready?
They're in on this one.
Fucking Don Corleone.
Don Corleone.
He'll do fucking Marlon Brando.
Motherfucker.
I like that.
All right.
That one stinks.
This is a winner takes all.
I have to wait. Give me a 10 back. This is.
But what about my 2 fives? Though they learn fast.
All right, now how does this work?
I'm doing an impression.
Because he might do two. Two people might be right, so that's the first guy's right.
First guy.
Nothing. It's all
first
nothing.
Guy.
It's
first all guy. Right. It's whoever, whatever impression comes up first, and if it goes to the end without it, but it won't, he will do one of these fucking
My ten's coming. I'm
how
in.
Is there $42 in there? How dumb are we? $10
these
each.
Motherfucking crooks.
My ten's coming, so it'll be 50
I put my
to
five.
The
five. There was, if we're going five.
I put a five 10. And five
yeah,
singles.
Fives, yeah.
10.
Oh, no, we're going
I
10.
I took a five and put a 10 in.
I put five and five singles, so yeah.
$35
here. Wait, we're doing 10 each.
Yeah, we're doing 10 each.
Oh, we're doing 10 each?
Oh, no, five each.
10.
10.
10?
Patrice really doesn't like to gamble.
I know.
He's trying to lower the minimum.
But Patrice is already in.
Here's
You're
my
10. Deep already.
Yeah.
Is that Kenny?
I had a borrow.
Kenny,
you're betting today. Kenny's bankrolling Opie.
Here's my fucking 10.
All right, Danny, you wrote everything down, right?
All right, yeah, set this up, Danny.
What do we have?
Let Danny set this up.
All right, well, so the person to win this pot will be the one to have the next impression that Rich Little does.
Yes.
So it doesn't matter. If he does two, whatever the first one was, is the winner.
Okay. Yep.
Ope has Tom Brokaw, mm-hmm. and has Jack Nicholson. Jim has Walter Cronkite. Patrice has Marlon Brando as Don Corleone. And Bill has Homer Simpson.
Okay. You know I have Marlon Brando as any character? Will you at least give me that?
Marlon Brando.
He might go stellar, too.
Yeah, you could go Marlon Brando.
Okay. Listen, you know what? I purposely didn't look at the phones. One we was an obvious choice, Schwarzenegger. Motherfucker, and I'm saying it now because everyone's bets are in.
He won't.
That's a big one.
Fuck!
In 2006, that's a huge
and
one.
And he's governor.
That's and a big he's one. Governor.
Oh, shit. That's a big one.
He's shit. The governator.
So who said? What did you change your bet?
No, I'm just saying.
You can't.
Oh, you're reading the fucking thing? Fuck
no,
that.
You didn't hear me.
I just said
I didn't read on purpose, and now I'm doing it for the holy shit moment that we just got.
Right, we're all
no
in.
One got Schwarzenegger.
We're all
no,
in.
I got Brokaw. Danny said it.
I'd all say right. It's going to be the assassination of Anwar Sadat.
All right, let's roll.
Here we go. Come on.
or an Arab.
Oh, we need volume.
Sorry.
Saddam Hussein.
Hopefully the future. And he's always asking questions. A little annoying at times, but always asking questions.
Andy Rooney.
Here's a few things that bother me. Why do they sterilize needles for lethal injection?
Pause. If he said, because only fags are getting AIDS if you know anything about it. And a bunch of dope users, who cares if they're dead?
Seems I remember you could fuck a man in the ass without dying.
I like Bill Burr's Andy Rooney.
Oh, he starts off
high. It's the end of the, I was just going to say.
Seems I remember.
Yeah. Bill does the end of the Andy Rooney.
All right, let's roll. Come on.
Why did kamikaze pilots wear helmets? I don't understand that at all. Here's something else. If an asp in the grass is a snake, then why is a grasp in the ass a goose?
All right, so I wasn't like a big Opie and Anthony fan, but I did find this interesting when I kind of ran into these guys a couple of years ago.
You want to eat grapes and we'll do this after the break?
No, okay.
A lot of people know that Opie and Anthony got a divorce, I guess you could say, but this was the big on-air fight that really sealed the deal.
A lot of people have had...
A bunch of eat yogurt.
And another big thing that happened was, I guess, like Jimmy got a text from Anthony saying that he was such a, like, that Opie was a big fucking, you know, fucker and a, you know, an asshole and this and that. And he was real pissed off about that.
Huh?
I can't remember if that happened before or after this. Somebody in the chat probably knows.
That anymore.
I know. I just
started. I really don't. I realize that it's annoying, so I just, like, do it on the side.
All right. In 12 years, you could yell at me.
Whatever.
Come on, I'm fucking around. You're in a bad fucking mood.
I told you I
know,
been
but
in a
don't
bad
let it affect the
days.
Fucking show. You're in a bad
has
fucking
it?
Mood.
Has it the last 2 days?
Yes, it has.
No, it hasn't.
You've been in a cranky fucking mood. Mm-hmm. I understand we've been fired from fucking CBS and shit, but let me tell you something. I'm not the only one that notices. You're in a cranky fucking mood. Everyone's noticed.
Do you want me to start talking about what people notice about you? Leave it alone.
Yeah, tell me. Go
leave
ahead.
It alone.
Tell me what people notice about me.
Leave it alone.
I'm not leaving anything alone.
Leave it alone. Leave it alone.
Be honest. What happened?
You had a lot of moments over the last few years. Leave it alone. Seriously.
How did I have moments over the years?
Leave it alone. Just leave it alone.
Why leave it alone?
It was a little...
All right, so we have confirmation by Not Wendy the Retard, a.k.a. Aggro, that indeed the text was sent before this video, or before this on-air fight happened, okay?
Made a fucking joke.
So there's already tension. You know, there's been like this building tension. That and Anthony has, you know, for years and years has become like this big fucking, you know, he's basically Anthony could do a show by himself. And for a while, I think he'd been building the compound, you know, studio and shit like that. And was doing his own shit on the weekend. So it was... Even if he was just fucking around and just trying to figure out his own thing, it definitely put pressure on Sirius to be like, oh shit, we better give him what he wants, because dude, he's got a turkey operation in his basement.
Joke, it's a funny show.
I didn't go for the joke today, that's all.
You're fucking making faces at me.
Leave it alone.
I don't need faces.
Leave it alone. Seriously.
I'm not going to leave it alone. You didn't leave it alone. You're the one that made the fucking face when I'm making jokes. It's self-deprecating humor. We do it all the time. We goof on each other.
I go for the grape joke. Big fucking deal. If you want, you know, big deal. Just leave it alone.
I made a joke that for 12 fucking years, you rattled your spoon in the yogurt. It was funny. It became a bit with the fucking audience.
Leave it alone.
They understand exactly what the fuck we're talking about.
Leave it alone.
Leave it the fuck alone.
Leave it alone.
Holy shit.
You just because you're really into doing the show again, leave it alone. Seriously.
Really into doing the show again, as opposed to when I wasn't into doing the show.
You said people are talking. I mean, if you want to talk about people talking.
People talking?
Just leave it alone.
All right. We'll talk about what Chris Oliveira, how he told me how you were a lazy fuck and didn't want to do sponsors. You didn't want to go to sponsor meetings. That was part of the problem.
That it was always Opie yelling about how, oh, I won't go to a sponsor meeting. Fuck them. Have them come over here. And the reason Danny Bonaducci is still in Philly is because the guy apparently, even though he's got shit ratings, works his balls off and goes to every fucking meeting he's told to go
to.
We
went to every meeting.
We did.
Yeah.
I think I sat in that fucking room a lot more than you did.
No.
What?
No.
What?
No.
Who went to every Apple fucking meeting?
That was your thing.
My thing. You were supposed to be there.
You want
to
So, Agro says they started falling out after Ant's divorce. Opie's wife hated his girlfriend, Melinda, and Opie and her started distancing themselves from Ant because of it. Oh, okay. And then AOC says, did Melinda blow Jimmy? Ooh, good question.
No, they just wanted to look at our fucking stupid faces.
You want to compare that shit? Stop.
You know they just wanted to look at our stupid faces. I'm just bringing shit up. I'm bringing shit up.
Stop. You want to compare stuff. It's ridiculous.
You passive-aggressively threw that I wasn't interested in doing the show for some set period of time that you
said,
fucking did.
Because you said people have noticed and, you know.
Who noticed? Who noticed?
I'm just saying.
Give me a fucking name.
I'm just saying it works both ways.
Give me a name. Who noticed? Who noticed I went through a period where I didn't want to do the show?
It works
both
ways.
Or was that Opie's interpretation? During one of your miserable phases that I didn't want to do the fucking show.
Don't worry, dude. This will be over soon. You go your way, I go mine. Trust
See, that
me.
Would... Oh,
Trust me.
Oh, I could bring up the fact that you've mentioned that 80 fucking times in the past couple of months.
Because
that people have noticed, too. Hey, how come Opie keeps bringing that up?
Because that's really going to happen.
Why?
Because it's just time.
Why is it time?
Because we've done everything.
We've done everything?
Great radio. But it's time maybe to move on to some new challenges.
Is it?
Yes. Yeah, I think so.
Well, you brought it up enough times.
I think so.
Perhaps you want to.
And it has nothing to do with...
I actually enjoy coming in here and...
And it has nothing to do with...
I fucked up. Should we go down a little O&A wormhole and then wrap it up around 1 a.m.? I think that's what we'll do. We'll go down a little wormhole for Mojo in the chat. She doesn't know who these guys are, really.
Yes.
Okay. There's two.
Whatever. I don't need to snip back and forth. I'm gonna defend myself.
Let me start where we were instead of where we ended up. You got snippy at a fucking joke.
And his vile behavior.
Guy made.
Yeah, because I told you Monday or Tuesday that this whole losing a massive part of our audience is really frustrating. And I even said, look, I have to work through this emotion and get back to a place where I need to be. I'm not okay with what happened. I'm not okay
you
with what
I
happened.
You think I am? Do you think I am?
I'm not saying you are, but I explained to you why I might be snippy and a little on edge. I'm really frustrated and really pissed off at what happened.
No
and
shit.
And how we were treated.
Exactly.
Okay?
Well, that's something we can agree.
Now, I do play this clip quite often. And I feel like it's not played enough. Even as often as I play it, it needs to get out there. So I'm going to play it again right now. You guys check this out. I don't even know if I'll comment. Oh, there was my NOS can just kind of clicked on me there. You hear that?
I wonder about that. Like, when you perturb normal states of consciousness, when you take, like, the normal way you are and you start changing a little bit with a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of depression, a little bit of bad things, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I'll take a little Xanax, take the edge off. Then I'll take a Valium so I can go to sleep. Then I'll take an Ambien if the Valium doesn't work. And you keep going and going and going.
Oh, by the way, to steal Hostbuster's expression, this little guy right here, this little one, if you make a video criticizing him in any way, I think so. I had a video where I said, excuse me, let me get a drink real quick. I'm sorry, guys. One second. Oh, yeah, baby, that's good. Okay, listen. So, I made a video, and it was where he was talking to the guy with the eye patch. Don A actually has, Dan Crenshaw, right? Don A has a comment on there with, like, 200 likes. This video blew up, especially in, like, the past, like, 30, 40 days or something like that. I think I'm at like 100,000 views on this fucking video. But I titled it Joe Rogan throws Brendan Schaub under the bus, and all of a sudden all these people are like, "He didn't throw him under the bus. You need to retitle this." And I'm like, "You guys need to fucking settle down. Cry me a river already. My god." And they're like, you wasted your time. I'm like, you're wasting more time commenting on it. Like, you obviously care a lot. And they have no, and they usually when I say that, they don't have anything to say. I'll post the video link in the fucking chat in a minute. And you guys can go in there and have fun with these guys. But anyway, I was very surprised. He's got, like, people who are, like, religious about him, man. It's kind of creepy. Anyway, so Joe Rogan's talking to Jim Norton here.
Going, you're like, you know how like there's certain things you could do that can give you arthritis, right? There's certain things that corrode your joints. There's certain things you can do that make you tired. Like, the more chemicals you insert into your body, the more things you do, the more you shift from like your comfortable baseline of who you are when you're at your healthiest. You change. You become a different thing. And I think pot is just as likely to do that as anything. If you're doing it the wrong way, if you abuse it. I think alcohol can do it. I think pot can do it. Pills, speed, I think all those things can surely do it. But it's strange to see when someone starts to slip away and they start to go towards this like very strange version of them.
Now, Mojo, where do you think this conversation is going to end up? I'm curious. Before I play this anymore, I'd like to hear your prediction on where this video is going to end up. You would never think based on what, you know, how the intro, you know, started here. Where this is going to go
themselves, that you know they don't have control anymore. Is that how you felt like when you were a kid?
Yeah, from a very young age. It was a weird, but I was very addicted. It was like sexual addiction first. Like that was the first one. I mean,
sexual addiction was first? But you were drinking when you were 13, you said.
Yeah, but I mean, as a child, I was sexually active as a kid. Like fucking, I've 10 sexual partners before fourth grade.
What?
I've never told you that? Yeah, oh yeah.
How
is that weird? That's not weird, right? Like, that's totally, like, that's normal, right?
How was that possible?
I was blowing all my friends. I was a fucking, couldn't stop.
Notice the twitch, the eye twitch. Now, this is, I think this is one of his tells that Jim Norton might be either lying or trying to brush it off as it not being that serious. Like, see, this is the problem with Jimmy Norton. This probably never happened. None of this probably happened. He probably said it as a joke, kind of, you know, and he's like earlier in his act, and he's like he feels like he's in a Steve Renassisi, like, you know, I don't know, situation, I guess, where he has to be like, oh no, this really happened. And the lie kind of built over the years, and he was able to use the lie and kind of make edgy material out of it because he was like a dry drunk that no longer has, like, you know, he doesn't go out on the weekends and get fucking bombed and have all these stories to tell. So he's like, okay, I'll make up this lie about when I was a kid, I got, you know, I was blowing like 55 kids at a birthday party.
Blowing all my friends. I was a fucking, couldn't stop.
How did that get started?
You know, I don't remember the first one, but I remember there's a picture. I can date it because there's a picture of me when I was a kid when I split my head open. And I remember I split my head open running from the boy who was a year older.
Now let's get real for a second. There might be a third scenario. Maybe he was literally, maybe all this is really true, and he was molested, right? I mean, which is traumatic, but not, I mean, and he maybe the way that he got over it was talking about it on stage and making light of it, like turning his weaknesses into his strength, right? And now he has to spin it off like, oh no, I was a willing participant. No, you were sexually manipulated, Jim Norton.
Than me. And I used to blow him, but I was scared of him. He terrorized me, but I remember.
Now, oh, there we go, right here. Do you hear that? Let's hear that again. And hold on.
I was a kid when I split my head open. And I remember.
That kid hit him, I bet.
Split my head open running from the boy who was a year older than me. And I used to blow him, but I was scared of him. He terrorized me, but I remember him trying to fuck me once too, but I couldn't do it. Like, I vaguely remember I was in the hallway, my pants were down, and his fucking dick always smelled like fucking mothballs because he wore, dude, he wore fucking Budweiser bathing trunks. They had Budweiser on them.
Now look at Joe finds this like entertaining. He's really into the story. He loves the story. Watch him.
I remember him trying to fuck me once too, but I couldn't do it. Like, I vaguely remember I was in the hallway, my pants were down, and his fucking dick always smelled like fucking mothballs because he wore Dude, he wore fucking Budweiser, fucking mothball. I remember I was in the hallway, my pants were down, and his fucking dick always smelled like fucking mothballs because he wore.
Let's catch Joe. Dude, let's he
wore fucking.
Look at that! Look at that! He loves the mothball dick joke.
Budweiser bathing trunks. They had Budweiser on them, and he wore Budweiser bathing trunks.
So did he have like mothballs in his drawer, his dresser
he
drawer?
He must have, but that smell is a visceral memory I have of that kid. He's the kid that pissed in my mouth. I was in a public pool,
Joe,
in Edison, New Jersey. This is how young I was. I didn't know that. So I went and I was blowing him underwater, and then he goes, I popped up because he pissed in my mouth. So I popped up. I'm like, don't do that anymore. Anyway, all right.
Poor Jim's like extending like the, you know, is pouring his heart out here, like bringing up a traumatic issue. And Joe, rather than being articulate and having some type of like mature response, just laughs hysterically. Like, that's not a good look for this fucking story, bro. What are you thinking, Joe?
I put my foot down and then went back and he did it again. God. So I stopped cringe, blowing him, bro, at that moment.
That's
he pissed
hilarious.
In my mouth twice in the pool.
Dude, that is hilarious. So you're blowing him in the pool.
Yeah, I didn't think people could
underwater.
See me.
Underwater?
I was so young. If I can't see them, they can't see me. Like that. But the photo I have with the split on my head is 1973. So I was five. I know at that age, I was already involved. So I have an absolute photo that dates exactly.
So you were blowing kids when you were five?
Yeah.
So what do you think started that off?
Don't know. It must have been, just one kid. One kid opened the door. The rest of us fucking ran through it. I mean, I don't know. I just don't know what started it. I have very vague, fleeting memories.
So at 5 years old, you were all sexually active, you and your buddies?
Yeah, and then you got a little older, 6, 7, 8. Like, you know, it was, I don't remember who was first, who was second. I remember my one friend got erections and I didn't get them. Like, I didn't know what they were.
When he was five, he was getting around.
He might have been six
savage.
Or seven. He might have been, he might have been six or seven.
Giant rods at 6 years old.
But I remember not knowing. We used to count sucks. That's what it would do. Like, all right, I'll give you 10 and you give me 10. So you would have 1, 2, 3, and you would fucking count sucks.
Did you develop technique? Did you figure out, like, what's the best way to suck a dick?
I don't know. At that age, I don't think so, because I think it was all about getting you to do me after.
Oh, right.
I think that was kind of the goal.
Right, of course.
But there was a lot of it, man. Right, and I have, right, again, right, I can date it because I moved Halloween of fourth grade to North Brunswick. I think it was all about and you would fuck you, like, all right, I'll give you 10 and you give me 10. So you would have 1, 2, 3, and you would fucking count
sucks.
Did
you develop technique? Did you figure out, like, what's the best way to suck a dick?
I don't know. At that age, I don't think so, because I think it was all about getting you to do me after.
Oh, right.
I think that was kind of the goal.
Right, of course.
But there was a lot of it, man. And I have, again, I can date it because I moved Halloween of fourth grade to North Brunswick. So any experience that happened in this place, I know it happened before.
Oh, right. It was all about you getting your dick. So, oh, yeah, okay. All right, let's change the let's get off that. That's gross, right? I'm done with that. All right, here we go. Now, Ross only gave me 5 out of 10 stars for this.
Fake shaman, living at your grandma's house, sucking on the old titty, old nipple in your mouth. My bad, I'm a Chad. Turn down better weed than you had. I'm dead. Listen, 5-head dread, kill him dead. Just another fucking pleb in the streets. There's no cred to score, cause they had no game. Just a lame little cup. The fuck? Came here on a farmer's truck. My dick way bigger, and I'm about to trigger. Sound like you gargle razors, nigga. For real, what the fuck with the voice? Get your neck stomped on by Royce. You're spiritually enlightened, but frightened of a bar of soap and some wiping. You stink, maybe that's a kink, go figure. Go take a shower, nigga.
No, this was before
okay,
the
he's
riots.
A wigger. Think he got a car, but he get his pockets ran if he used that word. He a mark, he a bitch, he a snitch. And if I see him in person, I probably scratch that itch. Says he travel around the nation, but that's just a way of saying homeless sucking dick at gas stations. Hear the frustration in his enunciation, the utter stagnation in his total abdication. Ha ha, ksh, I fuck you up. It's on site, nigga, let me back it up. Strangle you with them braids, I tie a fucking noose. Fill up my clip and let them foldies loose. I'm strapped, keep Tommy on my lap. My suburban, I'm urban, and I'm splitting caps. All wigs, your digs, stab me for some cigs. I'm crazy motherfucker like Lieutenant Riggs.
Man, I'm getting too old for this shit.
You call yourself an American?
Yes, I'm American. All lives matter.
Oh, I'm fucked that's up on right, strings right now. Matter, so
don't you
can't
dare!
Can't find my little button to make this go to the screen.
This is his car.
All right, I need like a technical difficulty. Things like do 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 do. I need to get down his shit, dude. He's got it all figured out. One moment. Just a second. Let's play this one. I like this one.
We're not coming back from this.
This is not a troll. This.
I'll say I probably agree with 98% of what Roy says in this clip.
There's 1,200 health experts because now, remember we were told a couple weeks ago the virus doesn't discriminate. The virus now discriminates. If you want to get – to imply that the people that were marching were white supremacists because they wanted to go back to work is so – it's so subversive. You know, it's so it's such a scummy thing to say about people, to label people like that because they wanted to go back to work. And to tell you that they support this protest because this deadly virus that's going to now be spread across 1,200 health experts are supporting this. Just to show you, for all the people that were telling us we have to listen to these scientists, science doesn't matter. These health experts don't care about. Remember, how many times have we listened to these health experts don't care about politics? Politics don't matter to these people. What matters is the public health.
All right. So a few weeks ago, a month ago, I tried a little experiment. I did a complete clickbait video, right? It's Chris D'Elia tells Joe Rogan how he pooped in a guy's yard to meet Eminem. All right? Fucking garbage. It's a garbage clip. 1.5K views. I pour my heart and soul into this rap video against Cosmic Cam. It has 143 views. You know what I mean? This is why you got to decide what the fuck you're doing on here. Is like, are you here for views and clicks, or are you here for fucking to bullshit and have fun and meet people and talk, right? I mean, if you can do both, God bless. But you got to figure that out. For me, it's like kind of, it's kind of an in-between thing. I mean, I like new people coming around, so I got to try to get new eyes here and there. I can't just do the same old shit. I'll have the same people around, right? Kind of like it's kind of nice to pop on and at least have like, you know, 15-20 people listen to you, right? So yeah, there's that. Anyway, let's play this.
Yes, it does. Politics always matter to these people. They just showed you their hand. They showed you their hand and they told you that your protests are spreading the virus, but the black protest isn't spreading the Black Lives Matter protest isn't spreading the virus. You're not allowed to go to your gym. You're not allowed to go bury a loved one. You're not allowed to go to church. You're not allowed to go fishing. But Black Lives Matter groups are allowed to gather in the streets without social distancing. Now, I'll say this. I think, and this is not me saying, this isn't me saying they should be allowed to protest. I don't care. But then so should everybody else. This is such a divisive statement that is going to only throw more gasoline on the fire. That's all they're doing now. They want it to get worse. Don't all of these people that were yelling at me in my timeline on Facebook, on Twitter, telling me that this was all science-based, it's not political, it's all about science, Fauci's an American hero. It was always political. It was always about control. Because they have to allow these people to go out. These people can't go out and go to work in a lot of situations, but they can go and protest. You, look at me, you don't have the same rights.
My favorite part as other people.
You don't have them. You don't have them. They're gone.
As soon as I saw that, I was like, I'm clipping this, dude. That was so, I don't know what you want to call that, but it was so.
But they can go and protest. You, look at me. You don't have the same rights as other people. You don't have them. You don't have them. They're gone. You are now the lower class. You are now the you are now the serfs. You
Oh guys, the rap I was kidding. I was teasing about. I was like using it as an example just to say that like you can be creative all you want. You can, I mean, Jarba is like a Da Vinci, right? But you know, some when she gets on her stream, she gets like what, two live streamers, and that's fine, whatever. She probably does it for whatever different reasons. She knows that she can, but it's weird because Jarba also does clickbait titles. She'll be like, lesbians on the beach doing ASMR naked, you know, and all kinds of shit like that. So, but sometimes she does get like 3,000 or 4,000 views on her video, but. Jarba's an interesting case. I don't know why I went there with her, but what I guess I'm saying is like there's definitely a balance because you don't want to just be talking to nobody. I still would, you know, and I have. But my point is, I guess it's nice when new eyes come in and mix things up and kind of shape your
community,
you know.
You don't have the same rights as everybody else. All men are no longer created equal, folks. We're done. We're done.
Oh, well, I'm sorry.
Dirty Rob. You got suckered, bro.
I already know, Cosmic. Go ahead.
Dirty Rob, the Jew King, is he suspects that that's what you're up to. But I don't know yet. I mean, Kenny, I think sometimes I see moments of brilliance
in
you.
Yeah, and I got some comments for Dirty Rob, too.
Oh, Cosmic's on fire, man.
Shit.
I love this. This is why you have to have Cosmic on your stream. I'm sorry. We had
fucking
to feed
Dirty
the
Rob, that shit-stirring asshole. I love Dirty Cosmic, Rob, but he's a
Cosmic,
shit-stirring.
Cosmic, you took some high heat from your boy Kyle tonight.
Yeah.
Man. Are you going to clap back on that ass?
Oh, wait. Kenny left. Okay. Oh. Fucking piece of shit, phony-ass Mark Glista. Here's the thing I don't like about Mark Glista.
Kyle stream. This is from the great Kyle Wars back of circa 2019, Christmas of 2018, I think, right?
Mark Glista is in the chat section of Kyle's stream tonight, talking mad shit, mad crazy shit. But I know for a fact that whenever Kyle starts up another starts the Discord again, there's going to be Mark Glista sitting in there talking like old Chuck.
Hey,
fucking
Cosmic,
phony.
That was
fucking Dirty
Mark
Rob.
Glista, you dummy.
Old Chuck, is that like a known... I've never heard that before. I'm going to start using that motherfucker. Cosmic's so like Southern.
Fucking that Dirty Rob.
I'll say this, though, and this is going to be controversial. This might get me some heat from Cosmic, but I'll say this. Cosmic's white passing.
It's Mark.
Listen, Rostock, I know. Oh, well, I'm sorry, Mark. Dirty Rob. Dirty Rob.
Suckered, bro.
I already know, Cosmic. Go ahead.
Dirty Rob.
Cringe to hear your own laugh.
Is like a big Rostock fan. So and Rostock, you're going to be upset. If you,
my homeboy.
I always expect you're not going to listen to Kyle's stream, but if you do, there was some definite Rostock bashing, and it all came from your boy, Dirty Rob, bringing you up. So, Kyle, how do you feel about Rob?
So to the new people, I guess, Cosmic used to be, he's a loyal man. And, he's like Ross's guy, you know, he's the right-hand man, right? There was a time when Cosmic was loyal to Kyle and we couldn't, he was hanging out and everything and it was cool, but we had to like, kind of like pull him and pry him away from, like, Kyle's a bad guy, man. He's evil. No, guys, I know people like him. He's just a hood nigga. He's fine. I love him. And finally, somehow Dez got involved and pried Cosmic out. So, and now he's a beloved member of the RDA.
Ross Dog, like stirring the pot on purpose. And they're going,
exactly
what's Ross Dog's
real
name?
I believe that was his words, was he was stirring the pot.
If Kyle does have your name, let's just say he does. The off chance he does, the less than 25% chance that he does. If he did say your name tonight, it's because fucking Dirty Rob wanted him to say.
No,
say
if
Ross
he says
Dog's
it,
name, then.
No, if he says it, it's because he's a piece of shit.
Oh, but I'm just saying, Ross Dog's is like Kyle's not bringing you up just out of nowhere. It's little like fucking.
I can't tell. Does Cosmic have a deep voice or not? I can't tell. It sounds deep, right?
Shit stirs like okay, Dirty that's Rob. Fine, I man. Love. I love Dirty Rob. I love
that's the world.
Dirty Rob.
That's the world we live in.
Or does it resonate at such a frequency that it's like a harmonic and it goes? I don't know. I don't know. I want to get into like you know, all that bullshit.
Yeah.
So good.
Kyle did a stream tonight.
But I would be Rostock. You should understand. You should understand Rostock. I would never go on Kyle's show and be like, "So Kyle, how do you feel about Rostock?" Oh fucking oh, Rostock! He does this, that, and the third. He does this. Like that's just asking for issues. I feel like in this whole Rostock Sands thing. I feel like Dice and LB and Anthony. I feel like Jimmy Norton. I feel like I love them both. How am I gonna? I'm not gonna talk shit about Kyle, or I'm not gonna like I'll make fun of
yeah,
Kyle.
Yeah, no, I don't expect you to. So I don't make you choose. We're not Don A over here.
That was my point on my stream a little while ago when I said I'm a flawed person. I'm not perfect, you know. Like people were
hold on,
messy. That's past me. Okay, just to let you guys know.
He's trying to successfully navigate those murky waters. Nobody's ever been able to straddle those. The worst position you can be in is on the fence.
Trust me, Mark Glista knows. Trust me.
No, that is a Chicago. How do you put it? I think he sells. He's a pharmaceutical salesman named Mark Glista. And actually, Mark Glista was a badass, dude. He was it was so fun to do a stream with him. You couldn't, like, if I have somebody on here that has something to talk about, I can bounce off and talk about anything with him, right? But, like, Mark Glista always had something. He was, like, one of those guys who probably always watched CNN, and he just always had a talking point in his fucking up his sleeve, you know? And it's always nice to have a dude like that around.
You will not...
And he wasn't, like, he was playful. He wasn't confrontational to the point where people shut down. Like, that's not, that might be good for you. You made a power move, but at the end of the day, is it good for the audience who wants to hear, like, people bounce off each other and go back and forth, right, you know?
Successfully complete this level. I promise
I'll have
you.
I'll have Sam Hill in a few episodes going, Cosmic is a fucking dirty fence.
Yeah,
fuck him.
It'll start... That's how you know. It's like a
Oh, hello, Professor.
Professor Ian Ellis is in the house, guys.
Sam Hill is the patient zero of any social media virus. Once it turns on you and it turns contagious. Oh wait, did somebody just pop in?
Yeah, I popped in your mom.
Oh damn. Don't
oh, is this Dr. Peterson? What's up, Ian Ellis? How you been, buddy?
What's up, CEO?
I'm slow.
You hear about that, Mark? Do you hear that CEO keeps tricking Doug into thinking he's you?
Oh, I know. That's awesome. I got the Mark Glista troll in the chat that starts fights for me. And then I've got CEO that starts. I show up places and people are like, fuck you, man. What the fuck? Blah, 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 blah. I'm like, what? What happened?
To be fair, I commend that Mark Glista troll because he got me and he's still working hard every day just to
finish
the
game.
It's fucking weird.
He's good, man. He's got my respect.
I'm not.
I have a feeling it's clickbait, but it might be between me and clickbait.
I'm everybody, dude. You know that by now.
Clickbait.
What's with
the
breathing?
Like the
oh, that's Ian Ellis. What are you doing? What are you up to, buddy?
I'm wondering what kind of piece is Glista working with? Because he's real thirsty, so we got to know. Inquiring minds want to know.
It's an average dick. He said it. He spent enough time in the showers with the boys.
5.1 inches and 4.5 inches around them.
It used to be average when it could get hard.
Before the pharmaceuticals.
In the last century. Pre-9/11.
9/11.
His dick fell before the towers.
That was the last time he got hard.
Mark's
and he never forgot.
All right, you know what? Ian Ellis, let's go back and hear that again. That was a great joke.
The average when it could get hard.
I think that Ian Ellis has a never-ending list of 9/11 jokes because every time 9/11 comes up, he's got a zinger. Like when that one chick was fighting with him They were kind of like flirting back and forth that I don't know what she was, Iranian, I think she was. And she's like, we don't celebrate any holidays. And he's like, not even 9/11. I was like, Jesus Christ, dude. It was quick.
Before the pharmaceuticals.
In the last century, pre 9/11.
9/11.
His dick fell before the towers.
That was the last time he got hard.
Mark's and he never forgot.
You come in swiping like a cat, do you? Just because you're a wigger doesn't mean you have a big dick.
Meow.
No, Mark is sexually ambiguous on purpose. Oh my god, another great fucking joke by Mark Glista. People were funnier back then, I'm not gonna lie. There was some funny fucks going on.
Forgot.
You come in swiping like a cat, do you? Just because you're a wigger doesn't mean you have a big dick.
Oh. Fucking great joke, bro.
Meow.
No, Mark is sexually ambiguous on purpose. I get his angle.
Yeah, you gotta play that. You gotta play that middle lane, man.
It's edgy. It's an edgy move. I get it. Like that's the right, like when Professor right. Peterson said he sucked a penis. I mean, we've all went there.
Yeah,
well,
I mean,
he doesn't know. In fairness to Professor, in fairness to Professor Peterson, he doesn't know what happened. He woke up with what he
can
thought.
Can the wait jockey shut up?
From a, hey, what, he thought it was icing from a Krispy Kreme. Give me some icy hot,
jock. Okay, how about you do that? Why don't you go change your shorts, jock? The professor's talking.
Let the professor speak, please, Mark.
What do you have a degree in? Washing your towels?
Jock.
Showering with your flip-flops on? Yeah,
well,
keep telling
yourself, keep telling yourself when you got drunk you like Krispy Kreme donuts, because that stuff you woke up with on your mustache, that was just good.
Let's see here.
Still, when you called me last week, I told you, don't fucking take the pills and drink at the same time.
All right, what's 7 times 6?
Did I not tell you? Did I not tell you? Don't fucking take pills and drink. I told you that.
What's 6 times 8?
Then you're crying. I got to cry. I talk to you while you're crying, blubbering. Just take it easy, bro.
Okay. What's 43 times 0?
All right. Life is what you make it, like I says to you.
What's 0 times 1,658?
Do you guys remember this?
This lasted like an hour.
Oh, you don't know 0 times 1,600?
I'm not exaggerating.
You're
going to
keep trucking along, and I promise you, you're going to make it.
It was Jim or Nam asking Don A questions, and then like Don A finally resulted to just saying meatballs, and like so they're having like two different conversations with each other. Neither one of them, it's like a war of attrition, just a Chinaman versus a fucking Italian man.
Life.
What is 0 times negative 455?
Hey, you never know. You might make it up to the fry machine. Just okay. Keep fucking working. Keep paying attention.
All right, so in the chat, AOC says, Mike. So apparently Kyle got a huge shout-out on Red Bar Radio. And Mike said he supports Kyle and Jules likes him too. You know what I was thinking? And I'd like to know in the chat what you guys think. I think Belland is RDA's version of Jules, right? I mean, if not him, who?
Right?
0 times.
And that's not a diss. It's just, I feel like they grew up in the same neighborhood or something like that.
Times 1?
And don't pay attention to that ex-wife of yours.
Okay, so I guess you're a real retard. Holy shit.
Stay strong, bro.
Okay, dummy. Okay, bye, dummy.
Take it easy, bud. Love you.
Okay, loser.
Love you, loser.
Okay, bye, Hanzi. You fucking idiot.
Love you, Jam Jam.
Damn, you're the dumbest guy ever, dude. You're leaving.
I beat you again.
You're leaving while you're dumb.
I beat you again.
0 times 133. 0 times 133.
I want to know what the fuck you do for a living, and I want
you
to. You
don't know what 0 times 133 is, on loser.
You know, use your imagination. If you know, it doesn't have to be real. Just
man,
use your
you're
imagination.
You're so dumb.
Right?
God,
I should have listened
dumb.
To everybody and smashed Donnie, you on my show.
You are
I feel bad.
So
I feel bad.
Dumb.
I really should have fucking did this to you on my
Donnie
show.
Donnie is the biggest dummy in the world. Holy
but I knew you
shit.
Would have hung up and cried like a little broad.
Damn, so, Donnie, you're a fucking
I to,
idiot.
I wanted to keep you. You know,
holy
I wanted to try to keep
shit,
you lucid.
You're dumb. You are so
that,
dumb.
And you admitted that you were
Donnie
a hypocrite
is
on
the
show.
Dumbest fucking that idiot ever.
All right, let's check you out, bro.
Oh, I
can hear it.
Yeah, it's your song, fool.
Wow, wow, wow. Something persistent, it took up a sentence.
Cutting you off and on.
It, but took up the sentence. Wow, wow. You right, you right.
Cutting off and on.
That's what it does.
Got a note in the point shaped off. Couldn't avoid, so stoke waved off. Having a pull of the holes to take off. I'm fucking annoying, these noises lay off. Toy script, this is poison, days off. I two appointments to notice, lay pause. My aunt Luther had a disease.
It's like Jing's kind of grew on me. You know, it took a while for me to get through. Like at first it just sounded like mumble. But now it's kind of like, it's like before all I could see or hear was like the Matrix and just like green letters and numbers falling. And then after a while, it's just like I'm flying through the air when I'm listening to his shit. I fucking can like, you know, beat up all these agents with a stick. It's insane. Horrible analogy, but you get what I'm getting at here.
The rumor that he loved me, all to the tuned up catching the
Ross Dog says Jing's been working on his apology love note to me in about an hour.
Is the humor, let it deceive, sardonic and stupid, catch it to me. Pardon these tumors growing to me, could they fuck us for shit's sake? You didn't, but they forgot we find how they presented the scent fall off. No one listens to the list they cross from mustache to bus pass that fake voice to the ad gets smash you.
Now, if you look very closely over here in the corner, I don't know if my mouse is showing up on the stream. Don A is on a Kinko's type, I don't know. He's back there. You can see him.
Boy, something persistent, it took a percentage. Look for an inlet, but took up the sentence. Something persistent, it took a percentage. Look for an inlet, but took up the sentence. Wow, 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 wow. Small like over measure. Incest pause, handle pressure. Weighed up bad and awful. Gave them the stiff arm. So pull the pull from my resources. Abundance to greed and drive like niggas on porches. Tune to my beliefs of energy and pheromones. Let me know. I conversate, it's a burn slow. Provocative as the third show. I'm cute, how much does he earn though? Where's his current house and cloud? Wow, 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 wow. You right. Selfish me trying to
blow. Yeah, I think it's a Discord.
I just wanna say that I personally think Jarva's gonna make a great mother. I'm not a naysayer. I think she's going to, you know what? I've got faith in her. She's gonna take responsibility. She's gonna get herself a gerb, and take care of that little munchkin.
As my intentions,
25 to be fun. And her and Jing's are gonna raise it to be a very strong, you know, member of the society.
What I become, I don't wanna hear how are you. I wanna know that you give a fuck, you fucking that I can trust you, but I can't, and you can't. Call the fucking ambulance. I think my ego's die, my only company. No thought in what comes out of face holes. I still penetrate that gate though. Something persistent and took a percentage.
This is when the Don A war was at a full fever pitch. I mean, obviously.
What is that about?
Do what?
What the hell is all that about?
Oh, never mind. This is. My theory is completely busted now. We're gonna learn why this baby is definitely not Jinx's.
No, it's just about ex-girlfriend I had and whatnot.
Well, figured.
Wait, somebody in the chat says, sounds like he was fighting about money with a woman.
Who was?
Jinx.
No, I was actually fighting in front of her.
Alright, so I'm basically like a Wikipedia for this shit. The guy's like, that sounds like you're fighting with a woman. That's Tony. Tony was a former, the closest thing to what you could call a co-host for Unbleached, okay? I know he doesn't like that term.
Her, like about her having a fucking, like a miscarriage without me, like, knowing without, about whoa. It. And shit, you know.
Whoa.
Aside, dude.
Okay, let's get into that. You know, did she push herself down the stairs or something? Like,
do you mean she had an abortion?
No, I'm saying she's fuck off. And so
someone asked that question.
Hey, God. Oh, look.
Hey man, you want to be a streamer? You gotta be on it.
He doesn't want to be a streamer.
No, I mean you just threw me off. I mean, because I was like, you know, saying a story, and then like you threw me off and shit. And
no.
And she's like, no, I just had a, you know, I just wanted to kill this shit because, like, you know, you don't want
to. Oh my god! Yeah, but if she was pregnant, like, would you have been excited to have a kid?
I mean, yeah. I mean, I don't.
You're an idiot.
Kill nobody.
Theo has betrayed us, and he is now, butt fucking our sworn enemy, the Jammer Nam. Explain yourself.
Okay. Jammer Nam hates Don A. I hate Don A.
We need to bring out the tapes.
Which Your one disgusting was it? Behavior, according to Sans, has gotten you banned, not just from his show, but from everything.
Well, that's good for Sans. That's great. I'm sure he's banned from the U.S. Navy for punching a Samoan.
Banned from voting.
Yeah, he's banned from that. He's banned from having a weapon. Yeah, banned from voting.
Having his children live with him.
He should be banned. If you have 2 out of 4 kids be retarded, you should be banned from having kids. You don't have a good batting average.
Shep, you fucking old creepy faggot. Get the fuck out of here, dude.
Well, and if your kids aren't eating and you're drinking every night, you should also.
Yeah.
Well, he's losing all his shit. Repo Man's coming.
Awesome.
That's why he hides in the basement. They can't knock on the basement door. We want our laptop, motherfucker. You lispy bitch. I'm not down here, stupid. Nobody's home, stupid.
Who would you say is worse as far as like being on a show with them? Kyle or Kimmer?
Kyle. 100%.
Yeah, I agree.
100%.
He doesn't catch any jokes, ever.
Yeah, and he's just a repetitive fucking bumbling idiot.
Jimmer Jimmer will do this though. Jimmer will at least respond to a joke. Jimmer doesn't typically plow through fucking people. I mean, Jimmer will act like it wasn't a joke and it wasn't funny, but Kyle would just go, "Shut the fuck up."
You stupid.
Here's the thing, Kyle. I'm not one of your fucking kids. Make sense. I'm not one of your kids. You can't just roll a quarter on the ground and I'm going to just listen to you.
You're not afraid to sell out.
Oh, man. I hear kids screaming inside.
Is it selling out, though? I hate Don A, and he hates Don A.
It is somewhat selling out.
When he keeps Don A on the phone for fucking 59 minutes with math problems, and Don A goes, "I'm going to hang up. I'm leaving. This is stupid." And he goes, "Oh, it's 6 times 4. And then Donnie goes, "I'm not going to answer your question." And then it goes on for about an hour. I think that's
a bunch of mark-ass motherfucking bitches to me. You black as hell, man.
Nigga, fuck.
Silence, well.
I'm a pagan, baby. I celebrate any weekend holiday I want.
Oh, wait, what, right for this one, Rich. Let me get
I ain't putting this on my show. I ain't putting this on my channel.
Mr. Weather Sorceress, that is my job. That is what I do for a living. People do not
pop, get up and show everybody's whatever, but too bad I did. Yeah, it happens. Oh, wait. Shh.
On Skype, Jim is.
Yeah, and he's got a crazy echo.
You guys, is there still an echo?
Sorry. I said I got my gloves on because when that dude comes in talking shit about Michelle, we're going to go, man.
Well, yeah, that's who we should get in here. How do you think, Michelle, how do you think we could get...
What's on your forehead, bro?
What's that display picture?
I got nothing.
No, I've always been coughing, and I've been doing slams for a long time, and I've never puked. Never. Sorry. It's not about me. It's about you. That is not even a half a bottle. What are you guys saying, man?
It looks like everybody is saying puke, but...
Oh, I puked. No, I cough, and I did. I needed to do a couple bong hits to just get that stomach relaxation.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And then I just shadow boxed for a second. I just needed a moment to myself. I didn't puke that. I got it mixed with Mio drops. Why would I ever puke it? Once you get that buzz going, though, it's on fire, man. This will probably be about me real soon, bro.
Okay, that's fine. Probably be about me. Keep drinking. Keep drinking that
music, right?
You're over here going, so how doesn't the world figure out how to block things? It's called fucking filtering. When you turn the filter off, you can fucking play whatever the fuck you want.
Okay, no, I'm asking. Tell me that. Yeah.
How stupid is
like we never
Tony tonight, guys.
No, I'm out.
Oh shit, we never heard the likes of him again.
Alcohol and pills don't mix. I told you that last time. You called me last.
I get it.
No, it's just like, how do I fucking explain that to you? I don't, without coming off like it's.
He disappeared after this. Actually, we found out he hangs out in the BBG.
It's the most boring fucking thing in the world.
Yeah, but you go into a stream and you do TTS and somebody says, hey, this is Don A. Fuck you, Matt. That's all? They pay money to say that?
Are you trying to run an ad for it or something?
No. I'm trying to understand how it works.
How text-to-speech works?
I know how that works.
Do I need to fucking, like, do an ad for it? Like, what the fuck are you talking about, dude?
My question is,
when people fucking send me money, they usually send a little note with it. It's good stream. And it goes, bling, good stream. Usually, if you go to Asian Andy's stream, they're fucking going, you know, they're saying outrageous shit. That's usually what TTS is designed for. It's designed to say nice accolades to the streamer. And other communities use it for toxic shit. Like, dude, you don't fucking go out there and advertise, hey, we want toxic shit over here. Let's put that out there. No one's going to come over here and do it. They're going to be like, these guys are
f***ing this guy's a criminal, and he's fat and racist.
I'm not in here with a bullet point.
He thought he was exposing shit.
You guys like, right.
I'm not butthurt about anything. He's like, oh, wait, I'm going to expose him.
I'm not butthurt about anything. They're not my friends. What the fuck?
Just go hang out with your racist friends and ice Poseidon. Go back to ice Poseidon.
You lost. Ice Poseidon.
How did I lose, bro?
You work at Burger King and you're like 30. And you're white.
You're 30, bro. You're 30 on the internet talking
shit. But I'm not white.
You fucking kids.
And I'm not in the Discord claiming I'm bigger than I am, nigga.
You guys are lame, bro. You guys are the lamest fucking people I've ever seen.
I guess so, but you're in our shit.
You guys are losers, bro.
You work at Burger King,
get our lives together and get into Ice Poseidon's Discord. That makes
super
it cool.
Size it, bitch. To put so much onions on, faggot.
This is why Hillary Clinton.
Make our burgers right, loser.
After this guy,
this is why Hillary Clinton.
Look, Burger Flipper. Look, Burger Flipper. Make her shit
Trump
right.
Is a racist.
Burger Flipper.
Trump is
no,
a
wait,
racist.
Wait, wait, wait.
Support a racist.
He just supported racist.
Trump is a racist.
President.
Trump is a racist.
What a rebel, he said Trump's a racist. What a rebellious nigga. He's like Tupac. Trump's a racist. What a rebel.
Trump is a racist. Trump needs to deport himself.
My God, you talk that truth, brother.
Trump hates
you
everyone.
You talk that, yeah. Go against
dude,
Trump.
Trump hates
you're
everyone.
So rebellious
Trump
right now.
Everyone.
My God.
He will not
rebellious.
Divide us. He will not divide
us.
He will not divide us. He will not divide us.
Bring the rebellion. My God.
He will not divide us.
I think it's going to be HB, but you were funnier and funnier than me. I'm smarter than you.
Oh, you said that just so you could say you're smarter than me.
I was waiting for the one.
No, I said that because I've read more than one novel.
Guess what? I got street smart, you fucking queer.
Oh, F in the chat for Sam Hill, please.
Oh, I'm no queer. I got this.
I mean that in the old. See, if you read words from the like before it meant gay, you would know that I meant weird. I'm more well read than you.
The Old Testament.
You don't read. You know about the origins of the word queer.
All right, let's say you are smarter than me. All of that fucking impressiveness of that goes out the window because you're holding it over my head like a fucking door.
What's wrong with that?
Because it's embarrassing, dude. Nobody cares that you're more educated than me. People care what you do with it. People care what you accomplish in life.
Jay is not true. Of course, they care what I do with it, where I went, what my credibility is. But keep going, HB. This is kind of nice arguing with you. Go.
Point is that it's really, you come across as really unlikable when you say you're smart.
No.
somebody because you have a degree. Like, that's so douchey, dude.
So are
you don't hear her bragging about it all the time.
How dare you say that's douchey? I don't. I'm establishing credibility. Maybe you didn't want me to talk about you're not reading.
No, it's not when you establish credibility and say this is. I'm talking about this psychiatric thing from a psychiatric perspective because I have this degree. It's you saying I've read a lot. I'm Sam Hill. I have 15 degrees, and I'm better than you.
Hello, Danny, my old friend. I'd like to talk to you again.
Can we watch White Showers again?
Don Anus can get fucked. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. I'm a part of Hostbusters, and David Walsh knows me. You fuck, we could have been great. It's delusional, delusional. Right click.
Oh, Ross dog.
Right click, that fucking shit got me, bro.
My wife does not. Oh, Ross. The general is great, and he gave me a chance on my show, and it was a good show. I gave you your most views.
Oh, Joe Booney, that was the past, man.
And you hung up on me.
Oh, no. Skull fuck.
Hello, Lyman.
Hello.
How are you?
Hello. Fine. How are you?
I'm doing great. I've been watching the show for a while.
Oh, hi.
I have to say, I like what you're doing.
Oh, thanks. Thank you.
I was told about this stream because you were covering Opie and Anthony, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank well, you. Somebody, I mean, I've heard about them. Of course, and I didn't have much exposure to them.
Not much exposure. Right. Are you a fan from what you've seen so far?
I mean, there's definitely elements that are funny, for sure. I mean, but I think for me, more somebody had left a comment about, I guess, what happened with Anthony and the group that kind of came after him.
What was that? Because I kind of missed that part of it. I mean, I used to me and my pal Royce, we have a podcast, so we kind of steal some of their jokes and stuff, but mm-hmm. I don't entirely know what the rest of it was.
So, but I think I've heard of you before. I've heard of you.
I'm a little known on the internet, I guess you could say.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard them talk about you. You're Mersh.
Who talks about me?
Well, I guess people in the RDA community.
RDA?
Mm-hmm.
Are you talking about...
Ross Dog.
Ugh. Ross Dog. You know, Ross Dog's afraid of me.
Really?
Yeah, I told him I'd come down there. And I kick his spurg ass. And he said, I don't, I'm afraid. You know, he deleted his Discord twice. Cause,
really?
He said, what's wrong with the Discord we got? It works pretty good. And I told him mm-hmm. he didn't have enough.
I think most people can do a Mersh. It's just basically a low registry type of a thing that you do.
Bots in there. So now he's going to make a bunch of bots. But are you in their RDA Discord?
There we go, I got it.
Well, I was, but now I'm under attack from them. So they're attacking me. So
what are those spurgs doing?
Oh, God. Well, they're attacking me. I'm their new Jimmer, I guess. I'm their new, like, target. But yeah, they're doing the whole royal treatment, if you will.
They're treating you like you're royalty. That's beautiful.
Well, you know, I mean,
oh, you're joking. Oh my god.
I'm joking. Being sarcastic. This no, they're making memes. They're doing the listening parties to so I don't get views. They're dragging me.
Who do you think has a faster like 40 time, Mersh or Royce? I'm honestly interested in that. I think that maybe I think that, yeah, Mersh gets Royce in stamina, so, like, maybe he would get him, like, all the way around the track, but I think I can see Royce having some acceleration.
They're all that stuff, yeah.
Having a party in your honor?
Well,
a listening party?
It's two, so that they don't give me any views.
That's not right.
I know.
What you could do is do like I do on my channel and have view bots to like don't tell anybody this. But we use fake view bots and fake subscribers to inflate the numbers. Mm-hmm. And people think we got tons of people, but we really have three people hanging out watching it. Mm-hmm. And but it's great, you know. Except recently we got banned from YouTube because we were ranting too much about the certain group of people that you're not allowed to mention.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure you don't know what I'm talking about.
He's trying to get her to like talk about the Jays, you know.
You can tell that your mind isn't in the gutter. But go ahead. I'm sorry. I don't mean to talk.
Well, I mean, I'm guessing. So, do you know Aggro from RDA?
No, the only ones I know are Ross Dog and Ian Edwards or something like that.
Ian Ellis.
Yeah, Ian Ellis and like the associate or like the
LLC.
The LLC. There's some guy though. I forget what his name is. Like the co-manager or something.
Bellin.
Oh, there's Bellin. Bellin. Uh-huh. Bellin, his name is?
Bellin, yeah.
Oof.
Is that a real name?
Well, that's...
Is that a real name?
No, that's not... That's his name.
Yo, she's still... Yo, y'all are black. Y'all are black. Where's your dad? Oh, daddy server. Oh.
You got the whole squad laughing.
All right. Hey, everybody. Let's roast his dumb ass.
You laugh.
Yo, that nigga laughs.
He's no big stinker.
That was probably that shit made me want to kill myself. That's how bad it is.
He speaks in generalities.
What?
And you know, folks, let's be honest. How many of these on-air people would you want in your life? Would you want in your life? If they were your neighbors, you'd never want to see them. Let's be honest, folks. Let's be honest.
Nigga, are we at church?
Amen. Amen.
So, you know, I'm kind of getting a little mad.
Mm-hmm. Why are you talking like that?
Tell him I don't dox people.
Hold on. That nigga sound like a serial killer. That's how white people talk when they want to kill.
I'm gonna go 10 hours of my way, man. I'm gonna go 10 hours of out of my way, which is 20 hours, I guess. And I want to come say hello to your family.
Oh, that nigga sound like a school shooter. Hell no.
That's impossible. This guy let me stay in his apartment, and I slept on the couch, and sometimes he was a dope dealer.
Sam.
We're waiting, man. Bring it, man.
The fuck?
Sam.
The fuck? I'm trying to ask this nigga his name.
That was an antisocial. Who are you, Matt Stearns, man?
What the fuck?
That's stupid, man.
Yo, this nigga is high out of his mind.
I would transport marijuana for him. This guy took his hand and his fingers and rammed it up my butt, and he was masturbating. Hello?
Wait, he likes to get his woman in front of him, going down doggy style, and he's squeezing on the boobies, and I guess the milk comes out.
Are you gay?
And I know, because I have a master's in psychology.
You have a master's in psychology?
I don't trust that nigga.
I'm tasting the milk, kind of sour, in fact.
Okay, I'm gonna.
I think this video is the closest we will get to like Sam being in a movie like Dangerous Minds, where he's like some, you know, super white dude in like the hood teaching kids fucking geography or some shit.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Sam.
That might be a good idea from the.
Sam, you from Idaho.
Take your fucking shitty fucking fedora and go eat a dick.
Do we get into it, you guys? Like, do we get into this Violet 3 million thing? I don't know if that was Brokebark, because you could barely... They need to release the full tape, because I need to hear more of who's ever in that talking.
I still don't get what I still don't get what the fuck this Violet thing is even about. Like, is it tape with some chick?
Griggy, I can explain it. Griggy got butthurt about Matt being dismissive of his lack of talent. And he couldn't improvise any content, so he, you know, rage quit the show. And then he took snippets of Matt's voice and pasted it on some shitty video. It's not a real video. It's just something he made in his basement.
Oh, yeah. Okay, are we all saying, can we all agree now that the Radio Report is great? I've been saying it since day one.
Why do you think my opening is the Radio Report? But, the Griggy dude is such a fucking lame dude. Like, he looks like the bad guy from Men in Black 3, and he sounds like Dude Love. I don't like him, and I hate him.
Oh, my mother, I don't think you want smoke with me. Oh, you calling out the Griggy man?
Enough of that, dude, yeah. But, who gives a... Don't bring me into your Broke Bar world of battling with nobody Griggies and shit. I don't give a fuck about him.
Hey, he got Dave Landau, and you still haven't got us Joey Roses.
Well, I'm pretty sure I got a complete interview ban from all Compound Media people. I'm pretty sure that's in full effect. But
he also got Joe Booney, and Kyle didn't.
Nigga, you know, niggas, wait till my Chip Live podcast fucking video. That shit's going to be dope.
Are we all on the same page now? Is that what I'm understanding? We're all on the same page that was going on.
Oh yeah, Creighton is getting Dave Landau too. That fucking Compound Media press tour.
Take your fucking shitty fucking fedora and go eat a dick.
Mersh is 37. You know a great video I saw? Which I never saw before about Mersh. I never saw the Mersh Ripped Off Jokes video. It's a pretty interesting video. Yeah, I'm 35. They're getting old. The great video I saw was he ripped off, and then they played it, and they said Jim Norton, and he kind of, I get what his mindset was when he was doing it, but he never made it, so he did rip them off, but it's like, every comedian starts off, right? Yeah, but every comedian says when they start off, they do that. And Merce started off, he never made it. So he probably started off, just never made it. So maybe it's like that. Although, I think he ripped off Patrice's joke more than Jim Norton's, but...
Hey, you guys know how everybody says that...
Who cares?
The Unbleached ripped off Red Bar. Check this guy out.
I gotta go in the right order here. I'm your host, Mark Cuxberg, better known tonight as David Brinkman. We're gonna focus on something that happened last week. And what happened last week, first of all, let's get our drinks going, everybody. Hopefully you've got a Manhattan poured, you've got wine or whatever, a beer. So we're going to just get to sip in here and having a good time. But what happened last week is another show. A guy named Mike David out of Chicago, he talked about Blue Room. So I had a photo of this show. So he did a show in which he talked about Blue Room. So you can see on the screen, he did about 30 minutes of coverage in which he insinuated that Blue Room, that we stole his show. Just have a good time.
Yeah, Unbleached
with him.
Is alpha. This guy's beta.
Of Blue Room. There's no need. There's nothing to prove.
Beta.
Richard joins the group. It got kind of sick. And you're going to see this play out because he actually started.
Would Unbleached
videos
beat him in
about
arm wrestling?
Me. Yes.
I don't know.
Maybe. Let's just start watching the first
He's got working man strength.
Video here of Richard Forenbach, just so you guys can get an idea. Oh, great. I don't have Talking Blue episode one with the comments loaded up. So let's do a search real quick because I'd like to have the comments when we do this because he did live videos in the Blue Room group. So I'd like to go over those videos with the comments, like I said. So let's see if we can find the first one he did real quick. If not, we'll just have to go. Yeah, we'll just have to
watch
the first
one, I guess.
Is that even
blue? Because to me, that looks purple.
Without the comments, for the sake of time. So let's open this one up.
That looks like Grimace.
Talking Blue 1. This is our new fan show made by our buddy, Little Dick. Okay, let's just start watching him.
All right, guys, my baked meat is going to take like 15 or 20 minutes to cook here, so we're going to talk a little bit of Blue Room Radio.
I think Matt would take like a torque wrench and hit him, like spill fucking hot oil in his fucking face and then attack him like a spider monkey, bro.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Shout-outs to Loesch.
What about like a tables ladder chair match between him, Broke Bar, and Mike David? No, that would be badass. I would pay a lot of money for that.
All right, guys, my baked ZD is going to take like 15 or 20 minutes
Shit, this
to
isn't right. Fuck.
Cook here, so we're going to talk a little bit of Blue Room Radio. Shout-outs to Loesch.
Damn it, I got to go in the right order here.
All right, hey, guys.
Shit, can someone send me a link to the first Talking Blue? I've somehow screwed up the order here. Let's see here. Talking Blue. Let's see.
I like Matt's new look. He looks kind of like Jim Carrey from Me, Myself, and Irene.
Damn it. Because I got to play these in order. It's,
like
it's just not going to work.
A state trooper look.
So can somebody, can somebody send me the link to the first Talking Blue? Because I seem to have them out of order here.
I'll tell you what I look like right now.
Altogether.
Have you ever seen The Hateful Eight? I look like Mexican Bob right now.
Damn it. Let's try to find this.
I've let myself go horribly.
For Talking Blue, damn it.
This quarantine's got me like Howard Hughes, dude. It's not good. Well, I like to get my hair cut at a fucking, you know, professional place or whatever. So my hair's just long and strong right now. And the beard is unkempt.
This sucks. Let's see here. All right. Well, let's just go in. Let's see. Is this Talking Blue on?
All right, guys. My baked ZD is going to take like 15 or 20 minutes to
All right, let's just stop
so
here.
We're gonna talk.
AOC, I would do that, but I end up looking, for some reason, I'm like a big guy already. I end up looking like Shaq. I definitely look like that or like a convict. I don't know, man. like when I'm going to properties to check on shit, if I have a shaved head, I look like either, especially in this climate, it's not a good look to have a shaved head right now. But I look like a guy who's probably drinking and driving or I don't know, sketchy. When you got a bald head, you look like a, especially like if you're wearing like bright orange and shit, you look like a fucking escaped convict or some shit. It's a tough one.
A little bit of Blue Room Radio.
Can someone send me the link to,
shoutouts to Loge,
the first Talking
Glaive
Blue?
Orkia.
Kind of introduce him. He basically
and
went
I'm not even
going to
lie. You know, the carpet's matching the curtains right now.
Of his favorite radio show, Red Bar. He went on a crusade in defense. He sip, look, watch him sip on this cup. Watch this little sip
he
does.
Hi, Gino. This is a fake group, the real Blue Room group. He's built a bit of a following. And these people have no idea what this brings the guys up to. This is like the place they showed a tourist in Earth 3 to hide the reality. Yes, Ashley Butterfield nailed it. Sven, I'm going to murder him. Yeah, Jay, I requested that group too.
Okay.
He's not letting anybody
so,
in.
So there was someone in the chat said that they were going to murder me. Can only take that as a fun joke. Well, I of course won't take that seriously. I'm sure that was all in good humor. Okay, let's keep going. Going to be honest, he probably doesn't think. I don't know what that. I can't read. I don't even understand what that means. What is Red Bar? I'll explain it.
This
I know
is
I'm
Sam
to
Hill,
this
actually.
Times. The Red Bar is a show this week. Who's the host? Mike David, who we like a lot. He did.
I'm sorry, Hill, and I'm glad you asked that because it actually shook me out of like my trance. I need to go to fucking bed. I love all you guys. Thanks for hanging out. Shep Smith, you're an old, creepy, weird, fucking cyber bully, faggy, like, real estate mogul, bed and breakfast, fucking Airbnb, cringe lord, bitch. I don't know. Find something else to do, bro. You're a fucking bitch. Good night, everybody.